of Loan Depot. Yo, it's your boy Michael McFadden of Mornings with Michael and Friends, and I tell you what, Alvin, Jameson, and the crew, they really do it all. First-time home buyers, refinances, investment properties, VA home loans too. Hit them up. It's very simple. AlvinJameson.com. Y'all know Alvin like the chipmunk, Jameson like that fine whiskey. You can also hit them up by mobile phone, 404-587-9033. Once again, 404-587-9033. Alvin Jameson, Loan Depot. Tell them you heard it on Power 108.9. What up, Alvin? Question. Who has an idea for a new app? Well, if you answer yes to that question, it's time for you to holler at our friends over at Appsketeers. Yo, it's Michael McFadden of Power 108.9, and the crew over at Appsketeers will take great care of you. Nick and the gang provide you with the all-in-one app development experience. We're talking design, UI, UX, coding, and a whole bunch more. And if you have no clue what that means, it's time for you to holler at Appsketeers. Check out the website, appsketeers.com. Now, we're talking full confidentiality, no hassle, no obligation. If you don't believe me, just call them. 833-APP-IDEA. That's 833-APP-IDEA. As a matter of fact, you know what they do? They design, they build, and they launch. Tell them you heard it on Power 108.9. And don't forget to ask for the governor. What up, Nick?
If you hadn't made your way over to power108.9.com, you're just as bad as the people who didn't vote in this year's election.
The votes are still coming in. I'm going to give you a list of states that I'm never visiting, ever.
Oh, never, ever, ever.
F*** y'all state. I'm sorry, did I just cut?
You just cut.
I dropped the F-bomb, didn't I?
Straight. Early in the morning.
Power 108.9, a station for the people.
The team here at Power 108.9 wants to strongly encourage everyone to continue to practice social distancing and wearing a mask while... If you hadn't made your... Let's all work together to stop the spread of COVID-19 this holiday season. And if by chance you're in public and you hear someone talking like this...
Well, I can't see in this thing. I can't breathe in this thing and I can't ride in this thing.
Stop and just go the other way.
Power 108.9, a station for the people. Keep up with Power 108.9 on social media.
How can I find you?
Instagram.
At Power 108.9.
And Facebook.
At Power 108.9.
It's the exact same thing. It's at Power 108.9.
Oh. Oh, okay.
Power 108.9. A station for the people.
In a world of petty and immature people, it's refreshing to hear a morning show that has sophisticated hosts such as Michael McFadden and Jay Nash. Don't believe me? Take a listen.
But shout out to our friends over there, Credit Building Professionals. What up, Credit Craig?
I tried to come with you.
Yeah, thank you very much. You're
welcome.
That's what she said.
Ooh. Oh.
Hey.
Power 108.9, a station for the people.
The opinions and views expressed by this program are those of the program, program host, and guest, and do not necessarily reflect the views of Power 108.9 and its officials. We hope you enjoy.
Welcome, welcome. You're listening to In the Know with RJ Powell on Power 108.9. I'm back, y'all, in the building. Yes, yes, yes. Got a special guest in the house for you, Mr. Darren McCleary.
Hey, hey.
Hey, hey. Listen, y'all, today is February 1st, and you know what that means. Today is National Heart Month. So, Mr. Darren McCleary, we will be putting you guys in the know on 2021 health and fitness strategies, right?
Yeah.
To get your life snatched back together. Yes, I want to say happy Black History Month. Today is also National Freedom Day. The amendment was passed by Congress on January 31st, 1865. President Lincoln signed the amendment outlining slavery on February 1st, 1865, which became our 13th Amendment of the U.S. Constitution. So, thank you, thank you. Big ups for Mr. Lincoln. And, you know, we just want to celebrate Black History Month. We've been through so much in 2021. 2020, you know, 2020 was the year of death. That's what I like to say. 2020 was the year of death. In 2021, we want to make this the year of life. And part of that is taking care of our bodies, our health, and especially our hearts. Do you agree?
I agree wholeheartedly.
Yes. Wholeheartedly. Yeah. All right. So listen, everybody. We don't forget that 8 o'clock, No Atlanta Now Report. At the end of the show, we're going to have that In the Know Nugget. If you would like to call, please visit us on 678-383-2339. That's 678-383-2339. Before we go to our break, I just want to talk about the Super Bowl. Do you watch football?
You know what? The Lions, I'm from Detroit. We had this season. We lost every game. That was the last time I watched football.
So that's it for you, huh?
That's it. I was too emotionally invested. I'm not doing that to myself again. I've not watched. I think we went, 0-16 that year?
Oh, wow.
I can't do it. I was upset for months.
That's it.
I'm not doing that no more.
Well, you know, so many fans are that way. You know, their team is their team. And if the team don't make it, that is it. So, you know, we got Super Bowl next Sunday.
Yeah.
Okay, so the CDC is advising everyone not to, you know, group up and to possibly do, you know, their parties virtual. I don't know how that's going to look. Look at Michael over there. It's like, ain't nobody doing no virtual Super Bowl. What? Michael, who your team? Who you going for?
Nobody. I'm a diehard Falcons fan. I don't root for nobody but the Falcons.
That's right.
So.
You better go, boy. Listen, today's show is brought to you by Superior Products Coatings, located in Atlanta, Georgia. No matter what surfaces you're looking to protect, insulate, or reinforce, Superior Product Coatings provides innovative, durable, and sustainable industrial paint and coating systems that will help you insulate your building envelope and save you money. Please visit them at spcinfo.com or call 404-594-0083. Also, want to give a shout out over there at Level 10 Repairs on Pryor Street downtown. They repair smartphones, tablets, computers. Listen, AJ and Ant, y'all are doing your thing over there. Big ups. You guys took care of me. Please visit them at level10repairs.com. Again, you are listening to In the Know with RJ Powell. We're going to take a quick break and we will be right back.
Power 108.9 on social media.
How can I find you?
Instagram
at Power 108.9
and Facebook
at Power 108.9.
It's the exact same thing. It's at Power 108.9.
Oh, okay.
Power 108.9, a station for the people.
It's tax time, ladies and gentlemen, and this year, Mills Financial Group has some amazing programs for all of us, especially, though, if you're a truck driver, contract worker, real estate professional, and definitely those that are self-employed. Now, Mills Financial will get you the maximum refund you deserve. We're talking cash advances up to $9,500 in just 1 hour. Want to get started? Give them a call, 877-634-6299. Now, Mills Financial Group has several locations across the United States of America, including Philly, New Orleans, and our favorite location, the Battery Atlanta, home of the Atlanta Braves, making tax season that much easier for you. Call them, 877-634-6299. Now, 2020 was tough, and Mills Financial Group wants to help you get what you deserve during tax season. Hit them up, 877-634-6299, or visit the website Mills Financial Group. That's MILLZ financialgroup.com. They got your back.
And we're back. You're listening to In the Know with RJ Powell. And we are live in a studio on Power 108.9. Today, we are celebrating National Heart Month. So we got our guest in the building, Mr. Darren McCleary. Please help me welcome Mr. Darren McCleary. What's going on with you?
What's going on?
Listen, you know, I am happy to have you in the building and trying to get you on the show.
It's been a while.
Yes. Yeah. We were supposed to meet, last year on the movie premiere Natural. Mm-hmm. With Corey Eugene Productions.
Mm-hmm.
So I missed that opportunity, but I'm glad that we actually stayed in contact. Because, you know, what you're doing for the community is amazing. And, you know, I want you to, you know, be on this platform to share with everyone all the great things they can do to get their life together. All right. First, before we get started, tell the people where you're from, okay, and the name of your company.
Okay, so I am originally from Detroit, Michigan. I have identified with Atlanta so much, I'm close to saying I'm from Atlanta at this point. But, you know, I love my city. I'm from Detroit, and I am the owner of Thoroughbred Wellness. We went with calling it a wellness company because we do so much more than just training people. It's like a complete lifestyle change. So people are coming to me. I'm talking, we've gotten folks off of diabetes medication, asthma medication, all kind of stuff like that. So it's entire wellness, and it's all-encompassing. So Darren at Thoroughbred Wellness is what we're doing here.
And you know what? I'm glad that you mentioned the wellness part, because I know that you're an expert trainer and coach, but your company is a wellness company.
Wellness company, yeah.
And, I wanted to talk more about the wellness part, because, you know, with gyms, you know, you go in, you get your workout on, you get your sweat on, and you're gone.
Right.
But, you know, are you really, tackling your health issues?
Mm-hmm.
So I like what you said in terms of, you know, diabetes. People have heart disease. This is not just a place where you can come, you know, to burn fat and build muscle,
right,
but also get to a place of health and wellness.
Mm-hmm. Exactly. Yeah, that's what we do. We just, you know, my thing was, I always wanted to give back to the community. Like, growing up in Detroit, there was like a disassociation between, people were not putting together back in the day, you know, I'm 37, that, you know, what they were eating was correlating to their health later on down the road. I heard a lot of growing up, like, oh, well, you know, if you're going to get hit by a bus, you could die any day, that kind of stuff, you know,
right.
or God's plan and all this.
Yes.
And, you know,
if it was meant for God to have it that way, then that's how it should
exactly,
be.
Exactly. Mm-hmm. And I had a wake up call when I was younger. I'm actually vegan, and I was able to kind of overturn a lot of those generational, I don't want to call them nutritional curses, but I mean, that's what they really were. I was passed down some really bad information that would have killed us.
Mm.
And I was able to overcome high blood pressure, all that other stuff, through nothing but diet alone. So I was really happy to be able to share that with the community. And I mean, it's been great. Folks have been really receptive to what I've been putting out there, and I just want to keep doing it.
Now, you're a vegan.
I am a vegan,
How long you been vegan?
I've been vegan for, just 2-3 years now.
Okay, so right around the time when you went on the Ready to Love.
Yeah, it was
season 2.
Yeah,
we got to put that out there, y'all. Yes, he was a cast member on Ready to Love. I love that show.
Yeah.
Okay, I watch it every year.
Okay.
Season 2 was the show. That was about 2-3 years ago.
Yeah. Well, so I went vegan 2-3 years ago, but I haven't eaten meat in like 11 years. So I went vegetarian first. What happened, I had an uncle who, he actually died when I was really young, and he was really bad into the food, and it was kind of like, it flipped a switch in me because I was so close with him, and I was like, you know what, I can't go out like this, and there's got to be something that we could do, and that just literally started the journey that led to who I am and where I am now. So, I mean, if there was any positivity that could possibly come out of a family member's passing, that was the best that I could get out of that. I mean, it was a bad loss, but it changed my life permanently. And through that, I've been able to change a lot of other people's lives.
Now, with the vegan part.
Vegan.
Because so many people are vegan. Mm-hmm. And, you know, they feel if you're vegan, then...
Vegan don't mean healthy.
Yeah, that's the truth.
Don't mean healthy.
You can see, I've seen some overweight vegans.
Yeah.
And you wonder, what? How can they be overweight? Now, what are you substituting in terms of protein for your meat?
Okay. Well, let me answer. But this table is vegan. You understand that? Vegan just means it doesn't have any animal products in it, right? And people think that's synonymous with healthy, and it's not.
Mm-hmm.
Like, if I eat this table, I'm probably going to get sick.
Yes.
Or if I eat that wall, if it ain't got no animal products in it, I'm probably going to get sick.
Okay.
So, and then they done came with all this. See, you got me talking my passion now. They came, they came with all of this, this processed stuff, right? So it's the equivalent of eating McDonald's for vegans with these Beyond Burgers and these processed sausages. And that's why you're seeing this abundance of the overweight folks that you just referenced that are
absolutely
vegan, right?
Absolutely.
So real veganism, in my opinion, is supposed to be based on holistic plant-based. That's why the word plant-based has gotten so big now, is because people are moving away from saying veganism, because veganism has become so dirty, you know what I'm saying, because of all of the stuff I just talked about.
Okay.
And plant-based is really saying that, hey, you know, I'm eating whole plants, I'm eating whole vegetables, I'm eating whole fruits, as opposed to going to Whole Foods and getting that whole Beyond Burger, you know what I mean?
So
that's that. But your initial question was about the protein. Believe it or not, It's because I'm actually training to do a bodybuilding show right now.
Okay. So are you looking to be a bodybuilder yourself?
Well, since technically speaking, I will be a bodybuilder because I'm going to be doing a bodybuilding competition, but I'm not making a career out of it. It's just something that
I understand. Well, the people want to know. So y'all look out. Yes. Yeah. You'll be putting us in the know with your experience with bodybuilding, with your pictures and stuff.
Well, the show is coming up in June, so I'm training, doing it all natural, not taking anything that's not natural. You know what I mean? So that's coming up in June. But the protein piece that you're talking about, so the old school bodybuilding, you know, they always talk about that. You want to get 1 gram of protein per pound of body weight and all that kind of stuff like that. Mm-hmm. The thing is, your kidneys can't even process that much protein, right? Like, at all. You can't. I'm 230 pounds. I cannot process 230 pounds of protein in a day. So, and a lot of times, you end up excreting it. And then if you can't excrete it, it builds up in your kidneys and causes a whole bunch of issues.
I see.
So, to me, to circle back to your question about the protein, you really need about 0.03 to 0.05 grams of protein per pound of body weight if you really want to maintain muscle or gain muscle.
Okay.
So, I haven't really had to supplement a whole lot. I mean, I'm a huge advocate of Vega protein. It tastes delicious. It's made out of a bunch of whole, clean stuff. There's not a lot of artificial fillers. So I'll do a shake or two of that a day. But, I mean, we've gotten really creative. I should have brought that. I got a whole vegan cookbook.
Oh, you got the vegan cookbook.
Got the vegan cookbook. So I'm talking we be eating vegan enchiladas, cauliflower. They got a lot of different things. Jackfruit is a huge thing people don't know about. If y'all ever get that vegan shrimp, it's actually based on that jackfruit. And I'm telling you, this stuff is delicious. So
And where can you get that from?
Well, they got jackfruit at, you can go to Whole Foods. Okay. You can go to.
That's if my store.
That's your store?
Oh, yes.
Okay. Okay. Well, there you go.
You know, so many people, you and I, we know these people. So many people want to eat better.
They do.
But they really just don't know how to eat better.
They don't.
And they don't have the discipline. And with all the information that's available to us, you know, on social media, on television, the information is there. Mm-hmm. But people are still having a problem with knowing what to eat. Mm-hmm. And I think, you know, I think part of that problem is we want what we want. You know, I don't eat greens, and if I do eat them, they got to be cooked down to the nutritional value is gone.
Exactly.
You know, I can't pull away from sugar. I'll eat a little bit of sugar. Maybe I don't eat a lot of sugar, you know, and even meats. You know, we're not eating our organic meats. We're eating a lot of meats filled with hormones. What do you have to say to that?
A lot.
I
mean, you just talk about a little bit of sugar versus a lot of sugar. My response to that is you're going to take a little bit of crack or a lot of crack or no crack. You know what I'm saying?
Because, sugar is, you know, and not to cut you off, but is just as addictive or if not more addictive than cocaine.
So let me tell you a story. Mm-hmm. Let me tell you a story right now. All right.
Okay.
See, this is what happened when you get me talking my passion. All right. So mice.
Talk.
So mice, this study was done about 6 years ago, and I think it was out of Oxford, if I'm quoting directly. I spent a lot of my time reading. So there was a study where mice were doing this really risky behavior, right? Like they were running around areas that had cat urine, right? So if you're a mouse, the number one place you want to stay away from is somewhere where you smell cat urine. Now, I don't know if y'all ever smell cat urine, but it's strong as hell. You can't say, hey, I don't know what that is. Like, you clearly know what this is, right? Mm-hmm. So what happens is there was a parasite that got into the mouse that is indigenous or its natural environment is the cat, and it influenced the mouse's brain so that the mouse would do this risky behavior and hang around in an area where the cat would eat the mouse, and then the parasite can get back to it. So I say that to bring it back to the food. We have tons of chemicals in our foods.
Yes.
We have tons of, especially if you eat meat, we have tons of parasites. That are acting on your brain. So if you're not sitting here, RJ, and if you're not consciously saying to yourself, I want a hamburger, and if you're just feeling something and it's not your thought, that is something else in you,
that
either a chemical or a parasite that's weighing in on your brain and that's influencing your behavior, your moods, and everything like that to get you to eat this stuff because you're feeding that thing. You're not feeding yourself. You're feeding that thing or you're feeding that addiction. So it's a lot deeper than people even understand.
It's a live organism inside of you.
It's a live organism.
Like I heard a doctor was talking with me the other day and even just talking about the COVID. It's a virus. It wants to find a way to live. And that goes with the same in terms of parasites.
Yeah.
We have these living organisms that are in us. And you're right. You won't even be thinking about sugar and certain things. And all of a sudden, it's like I'm craving.
Right.
I want it. And it's not you craving. It's the parasite. It wants to eat, and it wants what it wants.
It's like, I mean, I hate y'all gonna think I sound like Judge Mathis. It's like being a crackhead. Like literally, if you literally look at it,
yes.
And the way that people, you know, they talk about this hangry. You ever heard that hangry and the itis,
yes,
and all of this mess?
Yes, absolutely.
I don't get, if I don't eat, it's fine. Okay, I'll eat something later. If you substitute that behavior with a guy that's homeless on the street, mm-hmm. and he's like, oh, I need, I'm hungry, get away from me. Mm-hmm. Y'all can be like, oh, well, he's fiending for his fix, right? But people don't equate that same behavior to food. It's the exact same behavior across the board. So addiction is a real thing. We call it, in the industry, we call it STAD, the Standard American Diet. And it's so filled with chemicals that people literally don't understand that Subway was exposed recently for having.
Is that the tuna?
The tuna was a second exposure.
Okay.
But the chicken was only 49% chicken and 51% chemicals, right? So to let that break down in your brain. 49% of this stuff is real chicken, and the rest is synthetic chemicals. What are those chemicals doing when they're interacting with our brain, when they're interacting with our nervous systems,
yes.
with the entire body?
DNA.
DNA, yeah.
Everything,
mm-hmm. right? So these chemicals are changing the makeup of your brain, your desires, your wants, and all of that stuff. And folks are becoming food crackheads.
But that is the truth.
I'm just telling the truth. That's what it is.
That's exactly what it is. You know, when we come up with these ailments with our bodies, from high blood pressure to diabetes, and you go into the doctor's office, and the first thing they ask you is about your parents.
Yeah.
Do your parents have it?
Oh,
you know,
God.
Did your uncle have it? Did your grandmama have it? And they'll say, oh, well, yes. I said, well, it runs in your family. And my thing is, you know, if you go back to, if you track what they're eating,
yeah.
they probably have the same diet as their parents or certain family members. And so if you're eating the same thing, you're going to get the same results.
You are going to get the complete same results. And hear this, whoever's listening and everybody in here today, let me tell y'all
yes.
something. I train quite a few doctors, okay? So if you have a doctor that ever talks to you about heredity or anything being, you know, genetically passed down, have a talk with them about epigenetics, right? That's
okay.
the new science. Epigenetics talks about genetics on top of the genetic factor. So epi means on top of, right?
Right.
So epigenetics has proven factually in the past 10 to 15 years that our genes are like a blueprint. They don't turn themselves on and off. It's literally based on what you're exposed to. And the best study for that, all you have to do is look at two identical twins. If you take them, they have the exact same genetics, and the genes express themselves based on the environment. So if you have one that grows up one way in mm-hmm. one place and another that grows up in a completely different place, if their genes were in control, then no matter what they did, they would just look the same forever, right?
Mm.
But the environment has such a heavy influence on the way that these genes express themselves that people have really not taken that into account. So what it is when you talk about things being genetic, it's like 1-2% of diseases are actually genetic based. Like, so in all of the diseases that exist that we know of, only 1-2% of them are genuinely genetic that you can't do. The other 98% are environmental
and
based.
And we don't know that.
We don't know it. But y'all know now.
People aren't in the know about that. And so they take the excuse, well, you know, it runs in my family. That's why I'm big. And they just stay big because
crackhead.
They don't think that they can lose that weight. You should call them.
I'm just telling
food
you.
Food crackhead.
Food crackhead. That's what it is. I'm telling you.
Listen,
I deal
y'all.
With it all the time.
Y'all, please don't go nowhere. And keep in mind, you can go to power108.com. That's power108.com to listen to the show. If you are not able to be on Facebook, power108.9. .com power108.9.com. Yes. and look for the shows for In the Know, and you'll be able to listen to us whether you're in your car, whether you're at home, or whatever you're doing. Please share this information. Again, the number is 678-383-2339. We'll be right back after this quick break. I'm your host tonight, RJ Powell. You're listening to In the Know on Power 108.9.
Yo, looking for a new house? Then it's time for you to holler at our guy, the mortgage guy, Alvin Jameson of Loan Depot. Yo, it's your boy Michael McFadden of Mornings with Michael and Friends, and I tell you what, Alvin Jameson and the crew, they really do it all. First-time home buyers, refinances, investment properties, VA home loans too. Hit them up. It's very simple. Alvin Jameson, Chipmunkchipmunkchipmunkchipmunkchipmunkchipmunkchipmunkchipmunkchipmunkchipmunkchipmunkchipmunkchipmunkchipmunkchipmunkchipmunkchipmunkchipmunkchipmunkchipmunkchipmunkchipmunkchipmunkchipmunkchipmunkchipmunkchipmunkchipmunkchipmunkchipmunkchipmunkchipmunkchipmunkchipmunkchipmunkchipmunkchipmunkchipmunkchipmunkchipmunkchipmunkchipmunkchipmunkchipmunkchipmunkchipmunkchipmunkchipmunkchipmunkchipmunkchipmunkchipmunkchipmunkchipmunkchipmunkchipmunkchipmunkchipmunkchipmunkchipmunkchipmunkchipmunkchipmunkchipmunkchipmunkchipmunkchipmunkchipmunkchipmunkchipmunkchipmunkchipmunkchipmunkchipmunkchipmunkchipm Also, hit them up by mobile phone, 404-587-9033. Once again, 404-587-9033. Alvin Jameson, Loan Depot. Tell them you heard it on Power 108.9. What up, Alvin?
If you hadn't made your way over to power108.9.com, you're just as bad as the people who didn't vote in this year's election.
The votes are still coming in. I'm going to give you a list of states that I'm never visiting, ever.
Oh, never, ever, ever.
F*** y'all state. I'm sorry, did I just cut?
You just cut.
I dropped the F-bomb, didn't I?
Straight. Early bad. In the morning.
Power 108.9, a station for the people.
And we're back. I'm your host, RJ Powell. You're listening to In the Know on Power 108.9. Yes, today we are celebrating National Heart Month. National Heart Month. We want to, you know, make sure that we're taking care of our bodies. We are facing COVID-19. We are facing eating bad foods, just like me and Darren was talking about. Let me go ahead and reintroduce my special guest, Darren McCleary.
Hey.
Yes. So Darren McCleary is the owner of Thoroughbred Wellness. He is also ambassador to Alkaline. We're going to talk some more about that, how you got into that. Yes, he is also the former cast mate of season 2, Oprah's network, Ready to Love. Love it, love it, love it, with Will Packard. Mm-hmm. And also Celebrity Fitness.
Yeah, CFT, Celebrity Fitness Tour.
Yes.
With a cast member from that show that you mentioned, Brent Underwood. We started that company, and our first tour was set for March the 15th, mm-hmm. and COVID hit, and we never got to go.
Are you guys going to start it back up again?
Well, what we did in the interim is we have a online program actually called Biggest Loser Challenge with Tanya Winfield from season... They got so many seasons. Don't get me the line.
They have a lot of seasons.
But she was, she actually won.
Oh, look at that.
She was the biggest loser.
You go, Tanya.
Yeah. So what we did is we have a online program that we were focusing on in the interim. So we do that thing quarterly.
Mm-hmm.
So our next challenge should be coming up, I think, in March.
Okay.
So yeah, we've been doing that. But yeah, we would, you know, once folks, it's hard to go state to state, you know, because I'm not finna get sued if somebody is wearing a mask and trying to do the workout and they fall out. That's a recipe for disaster. Mm-hmm. So I can't do that one right now.
But are they winning anything other than losing weight? Is there a prize?
What's the
prize?
So we,
you know, folks will work out for a prize.
Oh my God. Yeah, we have a monetary prize. So what it is, you know, we get 50 folks that sign up, depending on who loses the most weight in that 60-90-day challenge, whichever one we're running, they win a monetary prize. And that prize varies. You know what I mean? I can't say the number right now because we don't have a sign up. I don't want to promise some money.
Yes, yes.
Depending on how many folks are in is how we're able to, you know, allocate out those that prize.
Okay. I'm looking on here. Let me see. We got some folks that have tuned in. Hey, y'all out there. Miss you guys. Yes, yes, yes. Give a shout out. We got Mr. Phillip. Hey, Amber. We got Eric, Lisa. We got a few of y'all on here. Yvonne. Let's read some of this. Let me see here. Yes, and I know Lisa is definitely, she is into vegan. Vegan protein is yummy. A lot of people don't think that vegan foods are yummy. And vegan foods are yummy. You just got to find the right ones,
you
right?
You do.
Yes?
You do, yeah, you do.
When you first became a vegan, how was that for you?
Wow, that's a tough question. That's a tough question. Well, see, because like I said, I was vegetarian before, so I don't want somebody out here. My experience is not going to be like if I'm just out here eating McDonald's and then just going vegan, right? I was already on the road for 7 years.
I see.
So I was able to transition
easily.
You see what I'm saying? Mm-hmm. So I don't want somebody to look at like, oh, Darren said his vegan, going vegan wasn't that hard and it tastes good. And it did for me. But like I said, I was on that path. So
I understand.
What I would recommend, or if you really want to go vegan, just like, you know how like when you're on a regular diet, you got those go-to recipes.
Mm-hmm.
You just have to find those new go-to recipes, and they just got to be vegan. That's it.
You know, we're big juicers in my home, and oh, so I've been a juicer for about a decade now, and I remember in the beginning, it did taste like grass. Okay, it did, but it's what's being put in it.
Yeah.
You know, a lot of leafy green vegetables,
mm-hmm.
you know, and not too many fruits with sugar in it. So it did. But I knew it was healthy, so I drank it. But the more, you know, and I was already on that path, you know, of health and fitness. But the more you do it, like, I can take it like it's nothing. It's like a smoothie now.
Yeah.
You know?
Well, your taste buds change.
My taste buds change. And also, I'm taming what we were talking about earlier. I'm taming all those, all that different bacteria in my body, all the all those living organisms that want me to eat the bad foods. You know, they're being tamed, and now when I'm drinking and eating what I'm supposed to eat, you love it.
You love
it.
You know,
you love it. You want those crunchy vegetables.
Yeah.
You don't want them cooked out. You want your good salads. You know, I just, you know, it's just so many of us out here that we push away those foods because we don't like how it tastes.
Yeah.
You know, but we don't eat, you know, for it to taste good. We have to eat because it's going to sustain
life. But
it
will, but it will taste good, though. You know what I'm saying?
If you
will
give eventually. Yourself a chance.
There's a, listen, the Bible, and, well, I don't know what people's religious views are here, but any religion, fasting is a huge aspect of Christianity, Islam, Buddhism, Taoism. You walk down the list, it's a huge thing. So what happens is when you do a 72-hour fast, right, I'm big on that. I advocate that my clients, and we do this stuff once every 4 months.
People should fast.
You really should fast. And we do what's called a water fast, and it's where you drink nothing but water, and you do that for 72 hours. And what happens in that 72 hours is your body is able to take all of that time and that energy that it was putting into digesting foods, okay, and especially if you're eating meat. If you're eating meat, about, they say something like 75 to 82% of your daily energetic expenditure goes to your digestion alone. If you're vegan, it's something like 40 or 50. But anyway, it's a lot of your energy goes to eating food or digesting food, right? So when you fast, your body is able to go in and heal itself and rejuvenate itself.
Yes.
You know what I'm saying?
Yes.
So I say all this to say that what happens is it's kind of like a hard reset. You do a three-day fast, and when you come out on the end of that 72 hours, your taste buds have reset.
That's true.
That is extremely true. So that's another way that folks could look at it if you want to make a switch, you know?
One of our Facebook comments is food is an addiction. We know. It's so important to give your body healthy and nutritious food. You know, I like to go to the teeth. You know, we have our blunt teeth. Our teeth aren't sharp.
Exactly.
Like an animal that eat meats.
Mm-hmm.
So our bodies were designed to eat food that come from the ground. Okay. Not processed food. Not these GMOs, not even the fast food, like you were saying, you know, about the Subway. And what was that number again? How much of the meat was not meat?
Synthetic, 51%.
Synthetic.
51%.
Now, how much of that do you think is in these other fast food restaurants?
Listen, don't pull up at no fast food restaurant. That's the best thing I could tell you. Just keep going. You know what I'm saying?
Everybody's left the Burger King and the McDonald's to go to Chick-fil-A.
Yeah.
You can't. I mean, the lines are wrapped around the block because... You know, they want that Chick-fil-A. They feel, well, it's real chicken. It's the best chicken that you can possibly have. What do you say to that?
Don't go to fast food restaurants. I mean, that's just the best thing. The easiest thing I could say is simply put. But it's the same thing, though. I can't speak to Chick-fil-A's chicken. I can't. I don't know anything about it. And I'm not going to misspeak or speak on anything that I don't know.
Yes.
But, you know, to put anything out in mass quantity very quickly, all day, every day, what's the term, quality over quantity or quantity over quality? You know what I'm saying? I don't see how you could do those kind of numbers with organic stuff or, you know, with non-GMO or non-modified stuff.
Exactly.
I'm not saying it ain't possible. I don't know. But I haven't done the research on Chick-fil-A.
And a lot of our foods are GMO.
They are.
Since actually the late 80s, GMO has been in our grocery stores.
Yeah.
Read your labels.
Read your labels.
You know, I did a show on that. I mean, read your labels. And those numbers, they do matter.
They matter.
You know, that number 9 is important. You wanted to start with the number 9. That's organic.
Organic. Completely organic.
Right?
And another thing that people don't know, you know, and at some point we as a people have to get together and say, is this deliberate or not? Everything can't just, by happenstance, disproportionately affect the African-American community. But GMOs have a drastically harder hit genetically on African-Americans. I mean, I was reading a study 2 weeks ago that was talking about supplements now have been, I don't know how much y'all know about DNA and how that works, but
yes,
your
the
DNA
deoxyribonucleic acid, the DNA.
Oh, so you know all about it then, all right.
Yes.
Doc, all right, my bad. But,
no, yes, talk, speak on it.
Well,
please.
Anyway, you know how it's in a spiral, you know what I mean? So the way that the DNA works is it's in a coil, and it's a spiral, and it loops around one another. They're talking about some of these supplements, and especially these GMOs, disproportionately caused the DNA to degrade and unravel in African Americans.
Wow.
On another
and
level.
That,
so yeah.
That alone will lead to a lot of health illnesses.
Yeah.
That alone. And you know what? Even with these genetic modified organisms that are in our food, it is changing up, you know, it's changing our bodies.
It is.
You know what I'm saying? And we're wondering, you know, why I can't lose weight. I don't eat a lot.
Yeah.
But I can't lose weight.
What?
Or I'm stressed and I'm angry all the time.
Yeah.
You know?
There's so much more that goes into weight loss. Like how you were saying, you remember earlier, like before the last break, you were talking about how there's a lot of information out there and folks can go and look on the internet.
Mm-hmm.
Well, there's kind of, in a way, at some points, I don't want to say too much information, but there's so much that you can kind of get lost in the sauce. You see what I'm saying? Because
okay.
I have a lot of clients that will come and they'll be like, hey, Darren, I'm trying this keto thing for a minute. Keto will get you to lose weight, but you'll die if you do it for 10 years. It'll give you a heart attack, real quick.
It's a lot of red meats involved in keto.
It's a lot of what it is you're basically going really high fat and no carbs almost. And but these fats in the long term will definitely clog your arteries, lead to high cholesterol, heart disease, all of that kind of stuff. So it's okay for weight loss in the short term,
okay,
but it's not good. But what I'm saying is you have keto on the one hand. Then you'll hear somebody talk about Atkins. Then they'll talk about Whole30. Then they'll ask me about intermittent fasting. You know what I'm saying? So there's so much information. And without having a fundamental understanding on how the body works and real weight loss, then you can get lost. And you'll try something and be like, oh, well, this worked for this amount of time. And then you'll stop. And then move on to the next, you know. But and every time folks take these gaps, they're putting back on that initial weight. So I understand, and I'm extremely empathetic to how somebody can get lost and confused in this thing, you know.
Yes, yes. And a lot of people, you know, don't want to do the homework.
Yeah, they don't.
It's the information is there. We don't want to do the homework. It's the same as, you know, buying whole foods. It's too expensive, is what we're hearing.
Well, they call that whole paycheck.
You
That's your
I'm
favorite place.
About.
Yeah, whole paycheck is what they call it.
Yeah, and not just at the Whole Foods restaurant, grocery store, but just Whole Foods, whole
it's
organic
a fallacy.
Foods.
It's not the truth.
Yes.
It's
but,
not the truth.
But we'll spend money on, you know, getting that hair done. You spend money, you know what I'm saying, you know, shopping or traveling, whatever it is. But we'll put money, our value systems are just, you know, not in order.
Yeah, I can
we'll,
agree.
We'll put the money, you know, into things that don't bring us good health and wellness. And the things that do bring good health and wellness, we substitute for cheaper foods, is what I'm saying.
I hear you.
It's the same way we substitute cooking versus going out. You know, folks don't want to cook no more.
Yeah. Yeah, I could agree 100% with you.
Well, I see that line on your forehead. How are you at home? Are you cooking?
Oh, yeah. Every day. We have one day a week that we allocate to eat out. And luckily in Atlanta, there are a lot of vegan food places.
There is.
There are a lot, and a lot of black-owned vegan food places
as well.
So I am very happy for that. So we like to do that once a week to patronize, you know, the black businesses and to eat out. But people are not cooking. That's just a fact.
No, they're not cooking.
You know, that's just a fact. And I would challenge anybody right here, right now to
challenge y'all.
You know, if you're talking about this price point and that, you know, because you ain't never went vegan before, but you're going to tell me it's too expensive to go and buy these vegetables, right? So what I'm saying is take a week, right, of your regular stuff. And I'm talking when you're getting your chicken and all this other stuff, because meat is drastically more expensive than any vegetable. All right.
Yes.
GMO meat is more expensive than any organic vegetable. So take your regular grocery bill at the end of the week, and then just for 1 week, you didn't even got to be organic. Just eat, don't eat no meat. Just only eat vegetables for 1 week, and look at your receipt there, and then look at your receipt from the week before. And I guarantee you, I'm talking about $100 difference on at least at the bare minimum, because you got to think meat is. What, for a 6 to 10 pound bag of chicken of the chicken quarters, that's like $7, $8, $9, $10 or something. Do you know the amount of bell peppers you can get for $9, $10? You know what I mean?
Oh, yeah.
You know the amount of spinach that you can get, arugula, kale, you know? So people, I don't know where that fallacy came from, and it's very prevalent in our society that eating organic is expensive. It can be, but it's not more expensive than eating meat. And to your point, what you were saying, I agree wholeheartedly. we got to change our priorities, and we have to put our priorities on ourselves and on our health, because, you know, what is that Gucci bag going to do for you if you're in a wheelchair, you know? Honestly.
I know that's right. I know that's right. You know, when we come back from the break, you know, I want to, because we're going to get into working out. Y'all, we're going to get into this working out and how to stay fit and fabulous for 2021. But I also want to talk about, you know, how important it is to have a partnership, you know, with someone that has the same desires as you have to live a healthy
lifestyle. Don't open that door. Don't open that door.
Yeah, we got to open that door. Because, you know, folks want to get healthy, but, you know, they got partners saying, nah, I don't want that. Yeah. Or, no, we ain't buying that. So, y'all, we thank you so much for watching the show and sharing the show. Please remember power1089.com. You can go there if you are no longer able to stay on Facebook and you just want to listen, okay? The number here is 678-383-2339. We'll be right back. You're listening to In the Know with RJ Powell on Power 108.9.
Yo, looking for a new house? Then it's time for you to holler at our guy, the mortgage guy, Alvin Jameson of Loan Depot. Yo, it's your boy Michael McFadden of Mornings with Michael and Friends, and I tell you what, Alvin Jameson and the crew, they really do it all. First-time home buyers, refinances, investment properties, VA home loans too. Hit them up. It's very simple. AlvinJameson.com. Y'all know Alvin like the chipmunk, Jameson like that fine whiskey. You can also hit him up by mobile phone, 404-587-9033. Once again, 404-587-9033. Alvin Jameson, Loan Depot. Tell him you heard it on Power 108.9. What up, Alvin? It's tax time, ladies and gentlemen, and this year, Mills Financial Group has some amazing programs for all of us, especially, though, if you're a truck driver, contract worker, real estate professional, and definitely those that are self-employed. Now, Mills Financial will get you the maximum refund you deserve. We're talking cash advances up to $9,500 in just 1 hour. Want to get started? Give them a call, 877-634-6299. Now, Mills Financial Group has several locations across the United States of America, including Philly, New Orleans, and our favorite location, the Battery Atlanta, home of the Atlanta Braves, making tax season that much easier for you. Call them, 877-634-6299. Now, 2020 was tough, and Mills Financial Group wants to help you get what you deserve during tax season. Hit them up, 877-634-6299, or visit the website Mills Financial Group. That's M-I-L-L-Z financialgroup.com. They got your back.
Tired of all that baloney they force feed you on social media?
Yes.
Then get connected to Power 108.9, a station for the people. Keep up with Power 108.9 on social media.
How can I find you?
Instagram.
At Power 108.9.
And Facebook.
At Power 108.9.
It's the exact same thing. It's at Power 108.9.
Oh, okay.
Power 108.9, a station for the people. The new normal podcast.
It better be served to me by some naked woman.
Yeah. Locker room talk. That's what boys do.
Sports.
Green and shiny.
And locker room talk.
Can't keep anything else in my freezer. Yeah. But at least I can drink a shit ton of whiskey with ice cubes.
This ain't your ordinary sports podcast. Check out the new normal podcast on power108.9.com every Saturday, 11 a.m. to 12 noon.
No f***ing way.
Power 108.9, a station for the people.
Everybody, and we're back. If you're just tuning in, we have Our special guest, Mr. Darren McClary, in the building today on In the Know. We're at Power 108.9. Hey, Darren.
Hey.
Darren's so cool, y'all. He's so cool. So Darren is the owner of Therabred Wellness. He is a celebrity fitness trainer. And no, he's just not training celebrities. And you can get more than just coming into his facility to get fit. They also actually have treatment programs to help you, you know, with your wellness, overall wellness. Right, Darren?
Yeah, right. It's a comprehensive program that we have. I mean, we have chiropractor, we have a physical therapist. We're really getting big into the mindfulness piece, so we're doing meditation, yoga, going to be looking at doing Reiki, all of that. So my goal
That's
is
wonderful.
When I open up this center downtown, it would have been open already, but COVID. But, the goal is to just have an all-encompassing wellness place where you can just come and just get well overall.
And put us in the know where it's located again.
Currently, I'm in Sandy Springs. So think Roswell Road and Abernathy. That's going to be the main junctions if you are interested in finding Therabred Wellness.
And what's the website again?
The website is therabredwellness.com.
Okay. You know what? That Therabred, I want to talk about. Where you got that name from? Is it because you're such a dog lover?
You know what?
What?
I'm going to be honest with you. So I'm from the North, and, you know, you grow up and you just hear all these crazy stories about the South, right? And I was driving with a lady friend back then through South Carolina, and I actually saw this club. It might have been a strip club for all I know. I don't know. But it was called Thoroughbreds. And I was like, wow, that just seems like a real
–
it really stuck with me. And I was like, I feel like that's a real good way to think about health. So I took the horse – for the logo and ended up going with a Pegasus.
Okay,
a horse
and you didn't go with a dog. You went with a horse.
Went with a horse, yeah, because I was told in the South that's what a thoroughbred is. I guess. I was in horse country somewhere. But yeah, it was that's how that came into being.
Well, you know, and for y'all that don't know, you know, when Darren was on OWN Network Season 2 Ready to Love, a dating reality show in Atlanta, you know, we all know Darren loved his dogs. Okay, y'all don't mess with Darren and his dogs now. Okay, before we went to the break, you know, I wanted to just a little bit just delve into, you know, partnerships, being in a partnership that allows you both to get healthy and you know, have a wellness lifestyle together. How important is that?
Let me ask you that. How important? I'm playing.
Come on now. Is it difficult for you? Let me ask you that. Has it been difficult for you, or do you have a partner that, you know, that sees what wellness and being fit and all that, you know, how important that is?
Well, I will say, to answer your initial question, that anything that you get into, if you have a supportive partner, is just going to make it an easier thing to do. You know what I mean? It's going to make it because, you know, we're not all going to have days where we're super strong or we're, you know, all together, or we're at the highest of our energy. So those are the opportunities where if you have a supportive mate or partner, they can pick you up and carry you on, you know. So at the place that I'm at now, honestly, I'm so deep into, I mean, you got to understand, I'm vegan. I'm working out 6 days a week. I drink nothing but alkaline water out of glass. It's
okay.
Doing activated charcoal. I really need to put y'all on that before I get done with this.
Hey, I know about the activated charcoal.
Oh, so you already have?
Yeah.
Okay. All right. Okay.
But that's why we're on the show, to put other folks in the know.
Okay.
Mm-hmm.
But about the partner, I'm at a point now where dating-wise for me, you know, I don't even see how I could talk to somebody who wasn't doing the same kind of things that I would.
Because that was my next question. Would you date someone who wasn't on that same path with you?
Unequivocally right now, no. It's no way I could do it. Like, honestly, the girl on the show, Ashima, that I was with, sweetheart, really, really, really good girl.
And I met Ashima. She's funny, too. I love her.
Super funny girl. Super, super cool girl. And honestly, what happened with us was, you know, for those who watched the show, my father had a heart attack and I left. And I came back, and I just was not in a mental place to try a relationship with nobody. I mean, I thought I was losing my dad. So,
and so for you all who don't know from the show, reality show Season 2, Ready to Love, Ashima was on this show. She's a comedian, and her and Darren actually made the love connection.
Yeah, we did. And it was, like I say, who knows what it could have been without my until that heart attack happened. But that heart attack happened, and I mean, I came back. They were really pressing me, production, to come back. And
yes.
I was like, nah, I ain't coming. And then, but my dad came out, and you know, my family was like, hey, just go finish that. And I did, but my mind just wasn't in it. So I didn't get a chance to, who knows what could have came with us, but we did try to cook a couple of times together. And I was like, no, girl. This, yeah, this yeah. is just not. You know, she would make jokes about this couple that she would see. It was this lady who was vegan and her husband wasn't. And she had a garden in Cali. Y'all can see this on YouTube. And the lady,
okay.
it was both in their 70s. The lady looked like she was 50, walking around doing everything. And the husband looked like he was about 90 in a wheelchair. And talking about, oh, I sure wish that I would have did that. And she was like, oh, that's going to be me and Darren. I'm like, nah, no, it's not. No, it's not.
Okay. You know, would you date someone who don't like dogs?
No.
That's
a quick no.
Been wanting to ask that question. That's a whole nother show because, and you tell me if you agree, should people, dog owners such as yourself, only date people that like dogs?
Well, it ain't even got to be a like. You could just be neutral. I would just say stay away from people that are vehemently. I didn't know that the girl was vehemently scared of dogs. You know what I'm saying? Nobody told me that. She never told me.
Well, and your dogs are big.
Yeah, they are two labs. I got two black labs. Okay. So, yeah, but if somebody is production set that up, I didn't know they set me up for that. I had no idea. So,
okay.
Nishima, we talked about it later, and they knew that, you know, she said she was very afraid of dogs, and they knew I was a very dog loving person. So, they didn't tell either of us what was happening, just had her pop up in my place. So, that's what that was about.
Yes. That part was so funny. I've been, dog lovers, I tend to ask, what happens if you meet someone and they don't like dogs? But, you know, we're talking about food. We're talking about health. We're talking about fitness. And it's really all the same thing. You know, you really want to, make sure that you're matching up with someone who buys into the same type of lifestyle that you have.
Yeah.
If you have a healthy lifestyle, you want someone who buys into that. Even if they come in and they come in eating chicken and burgers,
mm-hmm.
you know, and french fries all day, but they see what you're doing. You know, I began to adapt the healthy lifestyle that I have from my partner,
mm-hmm.
you know, who had been doing it 20 plus years, you know. And when you look at this person, you can see, oh, it's working. Whatever you're doing, it's working,
right.
you know. And so, you know, that's how I got on the train. And it is, it's very difficult if you're trying to live a healthy lifestyle, but you have a partner who just, you know, who don't even care.
Well, in my opinion, in the long run, I don't even think that, because, you know, once you're deep off into this health and lifestyle, health and wellness lifestyle,
mm-hmm.
your whole mindset changes, the way you see the world changes. So I don't even see how it could be possible. I would love to see the couple where there's a vegan that's really working out and doing their thing daily, and you got this person that's just eating fast food and not doing. I can't even see how that can exist personally. I'm just being honest, you know. So I've just noticed just the way that I think is drastically different since this lifestyle. I'm sure. What about you? I mean, you said you made the switch. You before you made the fitness switch compared to you now. What? How drastic of a difference is that as a person?
Okay. Well, let me put it on the table. And I normally don't get asked questions, but I'm gonna put it on the table. So I've been into fitness my whole life.
Okay.
I don't know nothing about that other stuff.
Okay.
You know, there was a time in my life, and you probably have the same story, and a lot of people probably have this story, where I was working so much that I couldn't do my running. I couldn't do my weight training. And because all I was doing was working from sun up to sundown, and I gained a lot of weight. And even with that weight, you know, I can still do the things that I had been doing before. But it did limit me, and it did cause my cholesterol levels to go up. And I was stressed because I'm so busy making money mm-hmm. and making sure, you know, I'm a realtor. So, you know, then I worked with Atlanta's leading builders building homes, and I was in every county that you can imagine. It was very stressful. That weight is not fun.
Yeah.
I had to get that weight up off of me.
Stress weight.
And you know, not a surgery. I just had to get back to the basics. You know, one, you got to buy into this thing. You got to love to want to work out. When it hurts, you got to love it. I love the pain, you know. And so it took Darren, it took running, swimming, fast walking, weights, ellipticals. I mean, I'm talking 3 hours a day, 6 days a week. Not 2 days, 6 days. Going in hard. Because I'm a true believer in, you know, if you do something that causes it to come off quick, it's going to come back.
Mm-hmm.
And that's not a lifestyle.
It's not.
You're doing it because you're trying to look good.
Mm-hmm.
You know, so So for me, I've always been into physical fitness, and I fell off the boat just for a little while. But when I got, you know, when I got my stuff back together, that's it for me.
Okay.
You know, and here I am. You know, I have 6 grandchildren.
Oh, wow. I never would have guessed.
Yes.
Never would have guessed.
So, you know, and this is a big year, you know, coming up for me, you know, with a birthday coming. It's a big, big year. So I am an avid when it comes to working out, being fit, and I'm constantly just trying to just share and talk with people who don't see a way out,
mm-hmm.
you know, because my hearts go out to these people who want change but don't know how to get to that change. Do you understand what I'm saying?
I do, yeah.
They won't eat right, and they're too lazy to work out and keep that going. You know, talk to us about how important it is not to just eat healthy, but to exercise, you know, and not just exercise or just for or because it's the new year or yeah. the summer coming. I'm trying to fit into that bathing suit, mm-hmm. but to really exercise and build muscle.
Yeah. Okay, so I can take all of that and flip that just a little bit. So mm-hmm. we have a saying in the training world, you can't out-train a poor diet. Now, what you just described is the one instance in how you can out-train a poor diet. When you hear about these people working out 2-3 hours a day, 6 days a week,
yeah,
that 90% of the population is not going to do that. They don't got that kind of commitment. You see what I'm saying?
Yes.
So if you're doing what you're doing, what you eat is 50-50. But for the average person who is out here, you want to come from a place where it's diet. If this was a pie chart, your diet would be about 50% of what you're doing. You would want to have about 40% of what you're doing, in my opinion, be strength training. So we're at, 90% there? And then 10%, I mean, I could adjust it, 10 to 15%
mm-hmm.
Being cardiovascular work. And let me explain to you why. I'm happy that you asked about weightlifting.
Yes.
So now we understand that when you do strength training, it increases something. So the more muscle that you walk around with on the daily increases something called a BMR, or your basal metabolic rate, right?
Mm-hmm,
and
mm-hmm.
the analogy I like to use when I'm talking about the BMR is this. So if we are both sitting at a red light in the exact same car, right?
Yes.
And if I'm sitting there and I'm just revving the gas and you just sitting there calmly, who's burning more gas? That's me
because I'm
hitting the pedal, right?
Yes.
So what happens is your body, when you have more muscle mass, and it doesn't have to be a lot, any kind of muscle mass, your body burns more calories just by sitting around when you've built up and sustained lean muscle mass. So that's the importance of building up lean muscle. So if you guys ever go to the gym, and, you know, because I get ladies all the time, oh, Darren, I don't want to look like Arnold Schwarzenegger. You're not.
You
are not going to
you
look like
not.
That. Do not be afraid of those weights. But whenever you go to the gym, if you look at the women that are the most fit and the women that are you know, have the tightest physiques mm-hmm. or, you know, that look the best generally. It's not
yes.
the people that are on the treadmill for 2 days straight. It's the women
it's the weight.
That are going over and that are building their
yes.
Their fundamental workout, their foundation from weight training.
That's
so
right.
I am a huge advocate of weight training. And, I mean, cardio for sure, you know, like you said, it's heart month. So we need that for the heart for sure, guaranteed. But weight training gets you that and some. And then this is another thing.
Mm-hmm.
I'm going to talk chemically here. People don't understand this. So after you weight train, so when you burn fat, your body has the ability to pull from either your glycogen stores or your fat stores, okay? So that's the way that works when you're trying to lose weight, okay? So when you are weight training, your body, because it's an anaerobic exercise, anaerobic means in the absence of oxygen, your body doesn't have the ability to burn fat when you're weight training. It can only pull from that glycogen store. So why not do the cardio after you've worked out? Because guess what? Like I just said, when you're doing cardio, you can pull from glycogen or fat. When you're doing weight training, you can only pull from fat. So why not deplete the glycogen altogether from mm-hmm. doing the weight training first and then go do the cardio so you ain't got no glycogen left, and then your body can only pull from fat. That makes the cardio training that much more effective. So that's a huge tip right there I just gave y'all. Do your strength training first, and then just hop on your treadmill 10, 20 minutes. You know what I'm saying?
You'll see a huge difference. That's that no nugget. So many people, you know, they do the cardio first.
They do. I see it all the time. I see it all the time.
Listen.
I see it all the time.
Because that has been me. And like I mentioned before, when I was going all in, COVID has slowed me down. So I got to get back. But when I was going all in, and people that know me, even someone watching the show tonight, they know I am anal when I'm on it. I'm very anal about my workout.
Mm-hmm.
And even with the cardio, I gotta go in for an hour. I gotta go in strong.
Please don't do that before you work before you lift the weights.
Please don't. Yeah,
but
you know, and your body gets so used to it that because if you're going every morning, early in the morning, mm-hmm. you're doing those hours, your body really just gets used to it. You can do that hour. You can go work out and do weights for 2 hours, and you feel.
And
just
that's
fine.
How amazing that the human body is, though. It'll adapt to a lot of stuff. That don't mean it's healthy for you.
That's true.
Like I was talking about them crackheads, it will adapt to McDonald's as much as you want. It will, but that does not mean that it's healthy
for
you.
Listening.
You know what I'm saying?
I'm listening. Yeah. Okay, so I'll put my cardio on the back end.
Yeah, so just all you got to do is reverse it. You can have the exact mm-hmm. same amount of time in the gym. Just reverse it, and I promise you, within 20, 30 days, you're going to see a drastic difference.
Because just getting back in now, it's, you know? I don't see how people go in just for an hour, personally. Yeah. But I understand, because even me trying to get back in there, you know, like yourself, you know, we like to ride bicycles and walk. But when you're getting back into that gym, you know, you're trying to get back to that place where you were, it's not easy. It's tough.
You know what? But a good place to be is when you get to a place. So, for example, if I don't hit the gym, I feel like this heaviness kind of on me or like mm-hmm. that. You know what I'm saying? Like, once you do get to a place, because it's not going to be painful all the time. It's only for the first couple weeks or so.
No more than 2 weeks.
And people think that, you know, you're going to be hurting like how you were hurting that first time. If that was the case, nobody would be in the gym. Ain't nobody trying to feel like they dying or they got, you know.
All the time.
Yeah. So that's the training effect. It wears off.
Yes. Now, okay. So, you know, folks are working out and they want to know, you know, how many reps you have to do, how many sets you have to do. So I'm from the old school. Mm-hmm. And, you know, in the 90s, early 90s, when I first began weight training, and I still hear a lot of trainers even now, you know, just do the 15, you know, do a few sets of 15 and 15 reps. Mm-hmm. I can't do that. I got to go to the 30 reps.
30 reps. Okay.
Yeah, because for each, you know, for each session or on that muscle, I really want to do 150 or 200, you know, reps on that muscle. Mm-hmm. Okay? And talk to me. Am I doing it wrong?
Well, I would not say that there's no such thing as doing it wrong.
Yeah, as long as you're in there doing it.
That is doing it for sure. But I don't know if y'all know about this guy named C.T. Fletcher. So there was this thing that we used to call overtraining in the fitness
world.
And
you can overwork the muscle.
They talk about you can overwork the muscle. But I'm starting to see that that's only for certain people. You know what I'm saying? Like, so C.T. said he did his arms every day, 5-6. If he was in the gym, he was doing arms, right? Mm-hmm. So I'm the kind of guy where I put things practically to the test as opposed to just, you know, going with the science, you know what
okay.
I mean? And I've seen a lot of guys that have not experienced any of these overtraining effects. So to answer your question, if the 30 reps is working for you, do it.
It's been working.
That completely goes against the orthodox of what we're taught.
I know.
But if you're seeing the results, you know what I mean? Now, the only question or the only thing I would say to you is when you're training, they say that you want to train to failure, as in like, so you can't do anymore. So when they're telling you
to burn it out.
Exactly. So when they're telling you to do the 8 to 15 or the, you know, like the 8 to 10 is a good or 10 to 15, you know, mm-hmm. 15 to 20 is what they call a warm up set. But when you get to that 20, you should not be able to do anymore. Like that 19 should be hard. And then that 20 is I'm stopping altogether. You know what I'm saying? Because you can just be going through the motions. I could sit up here and just do this with this phone 20 sometimes and mm-hmm. then just stop. And I'm not necessarily getting any benefit. The way that the body responds is you have to put it under stress that it's not used to. You see what I'm saying?
Absolutely.
So that's why we have to switch these regimens up. For somebody like you, if you're in the gym the way that you're saying you are, you probably need to be switching up your regimen probably like every 2 weeks.
I see what you're saying. I see what you're saying.
Because your body will adapt.
And I'm not doing, you know, my 25, 30 on some lightweight.
Yeah.
You know, because I'm not in there to play around.
Don't play around.
yeah, I'm not in there to play around. So I'm doing the weights. For me, for my body type, okay, and so many women, I'm sure, like myself, you know, you just have to put in extra. Mm-hmm. You know, I've had people look at me and they say, "Oh, you look good, you look great." They don't listen. It takes work.
You gotta work for it.
This ain't easy. This takes work.
You gotta work for
years
it.
Years and years of work. And when I was younger, that 15 reps, mm-hmm. that worked. you know. But the older you get, that don't work. That don't work no more. Not in terms, you know, of burning that fat, especially if you have any cellulite, ladies, anything like that. You got to go in hard, you know. And those little runs that you may do on the treadmill, no, you got to get outside and pick up, pick your feet up and put them down. And you got to run.
Yeah.
You know?
But I would comment on what you said earlier about how you had to take some time when you, you know, when you had your schedule and it got hectic. Will Smith said, if you stay ready, you ain't got to get ready, right? So,
we got to stay ready.
Don't lose it. Once you got it, keep it. And whatever you did to keep it, make that your lifestyle.
And that is what I'm talking about. Yeah. That's where I'm at now.
Okay.
You know, because we get off a little bit, and that's for all of us. I'm not just talking about, you know, myself. So many of us, you know, whether you're walking, whether you're jogging, whatever you are doing, we do get off. You know, and you know this. You're a trainer. This is your lifestyle. You have to wake up and open the doors. You know, but everybody ain't willing to get out of bed.
Yeah.
You know, and so I just implore everyone to stay consistent, because that's part of the 4 or 5 C's when I come back from, we come back from our No Atlanta Now report that I want to get into. So we are going to, we're going to go right on into it. All righty then. All right, y'all. So is it 8 o'clock? So we're a little bit after that 8 o'clock hour. We're going to go ahead with our No Atlanta Now report, putting you in the know on what's current, what's new, and what's trending. And we are not going to take up too much time on this today. Let's see here. All righty. First, I want to talk about these COVID testings and our vaccine testings. I know a lot of folks, we don't want to get vaccinated. All right. A lot of people are scared from being vaccinated. Yes, I see you over there, Darren. And for those who want to be, Michael, like, my hand is up. I'm scheduled to be vaccinated. But for those who really do want to be vaccinated, I know you're looking, and it is very hard to find locations to be vaccinated. Please go to dph.georgia.gov. This is not just for your COVID test, but this is also for several different vaccine locations. You will be surprised. I know a lot of them are saying they're not taking anyone, but do not give up. Keep trying and get vaccinated, okay? Also want to talk about Freddie Mac. All right, Freddie Mac. Y'all know Freddie Mac is the big mortgage giant. All right, so they just reported from 2010 to 2019, Atlanta has 718,000 people moving to the metro Atlanta. Freddie Mac has ranked Atlanta the fourth largest growing metro in the United States. Okay, go ATL. That's huge.
That is.
That is really huge. You know, Atlanta is the place to be.
It is.
Yeah, that's why you here.
That's why I'm here, all the way from Detroit.
And you ain't going back.
Hey. I'm here right now.
Also, an Atlanta man, he designed a text message tool to help you locate vaccine locations. I actually used this tool on Nextdoor.com when I saw his post. And let's talk about it a little bit. So, let's see here. His name is Ben Warlick, and he is the founder of tech startup Disco Droid in Atlanta. And he basically wrote a code so all of us can be able to find locations where we can be vaccinated. All you have to do is text the word VAX. That's capital V as in Victor, capital A, capital X. Okay, to 678-679-0250. That's 678-679-0250. Text the word VAX, and you will get a text reply, and they will keep you in the know as soon as locations come available for you to go ahead and be vaccinated. Last but not least, we're going to go ahead and put you in the know on that health inspection report. You know, with COVID, the restaurants are open, people are eating out. And, you know, you want to be in the know on who failed that report, right? Because if you fell in a report in COVID, you definitely don't want to, eat there until they're able to pass that health inspection. Our first restaurant is Lotus Chinese Restaurant. They're located on Roswell Road. That's Lotus Chinese Restaurant. I don't know why these Chinese restaurants, they be coming up on my report a lot. All right, y'all. So they made a 48. All right. Also, and we're just mentioning the ones that are in the Atlanta, Metro Atlanta area. Boston Fish Supreme. And, you know, Darren and I, we were just talking about eating out. You know, we don't want to take no business from anyone, especially y'all small businesses. But again, you know, you want to make sure that you're eating healthy. So Boston Fish Supreme, they're on Fulton Industrial Boulevard. They made a 43. These are low, low, low numbers, y'all. And the Sleepy Potato on Martin Luther King Jr. Drive, they made a 59, the Sleepy Potato. So that is your health inspection report from No Atlanta Now. And we will be right back, y'all. You're listening to In the Know with RJ Powell. We're on Power 108.9.
It's tax time, ladies and gentlemen, and this year, Mills Financial Group has some amazing programs for all of us, especially, though, if you're a truck driver, contract worker, real estate professional, and definitely those that are self-employed. Now, Mills Financial will get you the maximum refund you deserve. We're talking cash advances up to $9,500 in just 1 hour. Want to get started? Give them a call, 877-634-6299. Now, Mills Financial Group has several locations across the United States of America, including Philly, New Orleans, and our favorite location, the Battery Atlanta, home of the Atlanta Braves, making tax season that much easier for you. Call them, 877-634-6299. Now, 2020 was tough, and Mills Financial Group wants to help you get what you deserve during tax season. Hit them up, 877-634-6299, or visit the website Mills Financial Group. That's M-I-L-L-Z financialgroup.com. They got your back.
Honest question. Do you really know what's going on in the Metro Atlanta real estate market?
I own half of Atlanta. You believe that? Real estate.
Team Todd Realty Group. Atlanta has become a hotbed for real estate, and it's consistently growing by the day. Nikita Todd and the good folks with Team Todd Realty Group are here to assist you with any of your real estate needs.
Looking to buy a house?
What I would tell a first-time home buyer is to make sure that you have saved adequately.
Thinking about that investment property?
You reach out to me because, of course, I have a lot of resources.
Or trying to sell your house?
It's always best to consult with your realtor first. We have options to get your house on the market as quickly as possible. And we also have other options to where you can purchase with cash and sell your home later. So it's always best to consult a realtor because we have a lot of tricks of the trade that not everybody's privy to.
Don't wait another minute. Go to www.teamtoddrealty.com for more information. Team Todd Realty Group. This is an example of what not to say to someone on their birthday.
And I just was like, I don't want to look old. But you look great. You look great. I'm sorry.
Hold on, you throwing shots? Forever young.
Leg, did you hear that?
Mornings with Michael and Jay Nash. Only on Power 108.9. A station for the people.
And we're back. I'm your host, RJ Powell, on In the Know. You're listening to Power 108.9. I got my special guest in the house, Darren McClary.
We in here.
All right, y'all. So Darren McClary, he is a fitness coach and wellness trainer, and he and the name of his company is Thoroughbred Wellness. That's Thoroughbred Wellness, located in Sandy Springs.
Sandy Springs, yeah.
Located in Sandy Springs. Darren also is, you know, we didn't talk about alkaline water. He's also alkaline. He's also the ambassador to Alkaline. Put us a little bit more in the know about how you got started with being an ambassador for Alkaline and the benefits, right, of making sure your body is in an alkaline state.
Okay, so I got to be real careful with this. So I used to be an ambassador for this Alkaline company.
Okay.
I'm not going to speak on that company because we had to part our ways.
All right.
Due to some things I found out about the water production, so I'm not going to speak on that. But when we talk about water and being in an alkaline state, for all of y'all who have heard of Dr. Sebi or Sebi, as some folks call them, he really championed this and pioneered it, and he just let folks know that, you know, bacteria, pathogens, viruses, a lot of stuff just could not live in an alkaline state. So that's where the whole thing about having your body in an alkaline state comes from. You just want to make sure that you're drinking like a lot of alkaline water, eating alkaline foods, just because bacteria and other ailments and microscopic organisms can't thrive or live in alkaline states. They need an acidic, inflamed environment, honestly.
Mm-hmm, mm-hmm. You know, a lot of people don't know about alkaline foods. You know, a lot of green leafy vegetables are alkaline foods. You know, what are some of the other alkaline foods that you eat?
Oh, man, there's so many. Okay, so if you want to go, if you want to just be safe, right, and if you don't want to have to go get a hold, because Sabi has a list that you guys can look at online. Mm-hmm. But if you want to be safe, I would say you want to, with the exception of spinach, you want to go with anything that's green and leafy. So
yes.
Kale is going to be a good one, a lot of your peppers. Believe it or not, mm-hmm. I've known people that have turned their water. You could technically turn your water's pH alkaline by just putting lemon in it. But that doesn't do anything about the chemicals that's in the water. So you want to do that with some kind of filtered water or something.
That's right.
So to be safe, with the exception of spinach, I would say just go green and leafy.
That's a real simple one. Just go green and leafy.
Yeah, that's the easiest way. Mm-hmm. I mean, because I can call off a list all day, but, you know, green and leafy is the easiest way to do it.
Collard greens.
Collard greens.
You know, everybody wants to cook those collard greens, you know, for an hour, however long you cook them, and then eat them. But in my household, we juice collard greens.
Mm.
We grow them in our garden, and we juice them.
That's good. That's really good.
People don't know. They're not in the know of how, you know, effective collard greens are when it comes to your wellness.
To your wellness, mm-hmm. Yeah. And when you've cooked those greens for that hour and a half.
Anything green. It ain't no good.
It's no nutritional value. None. You're just getting it for that soggy taste at the end of it.
Mm-hmm,
and
mm-hmm.
then you done, you know, folks done put a neck bone in there with it too, you know what I mean? So it's just any of the nutritions that you were looking for is gone. It's not
gone.
There.
It's all for taste.
It's all for taste.
And that's the same, you know, when we're eating out and we order, and I'm not saying we in my house, so I'm talking about all of us, okay? We're eating out and we order green beans
mm-hmm.
or we order some broccoli.
Mm.
But when you eat it, well, first of all, just look at it.
Look at it.
Because the color
is
not going to be that light green,
mm-hmm.
that sharp green that you're looking for. It's going to be that dull green.
Yeah.
And already, I can look at it and tell.
You can tell.
All the nutrition is gone.
Stay away from this stuff. If they put butter on it, and oh, my God, oh, my God, oh, my God. If they have put salt on it, you want to stay all the way away from that Morton's table salt. That stuff will kill you.
Oh, please don't have the Morton's table salt.
Do not have the table salt.
I go to people's house and just throw
just
it in the garbage.
Just throw it on out. It's synthetic. Believe it or not, salt is actually really, really good for you.
It is. It's a mineral.
If you have real pink Himalayan or Himalayan, some type of sea salt.
That's my salt.
You see what I'm saying?
Yes.
But when you have this synthetic salt that is ripped of all of its nutritional values, it's mineral based, it's doing nothing but jacking your cholesterol. I'm not your cholesterol, I'm sorry, but your you know, it leads to water retention because your body's just trying to flush it out.
Right.
You know what I'm saying? And it leads to, in a lot of black folks, something called sodium sensitivity, which shoots your blood pressure through the roof.
Give you high blood pressure.
High blood pressure right through the roof. So you need to be careful with that. And then speaking of high blood pressure, can I say this real quick?
Yes, please.
I'm going to try to be as concise as possible.
Okay.
So there was a study that came out. Now, this is about to be some detail. So there was a study that came out that talked about high blood pressure. So when you get to the age of 70 and above, high blood pressure is actually a good thing. So what happens is this, and this is what the government or whoever's in charge, the FDA, these folks, they're not going to tell you. So what happens with high blood pressure is this. High blood pressure just basically means in your arterial wall, when you have a systolic and a diastolic, is when your heart beats and the artery contracts mm-hmm. and then it expands, okay? So, you know, the higher the pressure in there, that means that, you know, you can think of it like a car. Just the more pressure that there is in your veins and in your arteries, okay?
Yes.
So what's not being told to us is this. The blood pressure in and of itself is not the issue. The issue is the plaque on the walls, okay? So what happens is when you have high cholesterol and if you have a huge plaque arterial buildup, well, guess what? If your blood pressure is pumping naturally at a higher rate and is pumping through your arteries and your veins with higher pressure, if you put a blockage in there, it's going to be way more severe, and that's what leads to these heart attacks and these strokes and these aneurysms,
absolutely.
Right? So as opposed to getting people to attack and go in and say, hey, let's go ahead and just lower and get rid of the plaque out of our arteries to where blood pressure really at that point is a healthier thing the higher it is, they've come out with this medication that lowers your blood pressure so that when it still backs up around that plaque, because it's still backing up, it's just not enough to kill you anymore. Mm. You see what I'm saying? And you have to stay on that for the rest of your life. It's the same thing with the omega-3s and the omega-6s. I can go on and on. But it's just not the truth. So people, just be very careful about what you eat. And you really need to take your health into your own hands, because I have a lot of doctor friends, and they will tell you, they will be the first to tell you, Darren, I don't know nothing about nutrition. I don't know anything that nutrition is even.
You're preaching to the choir, because I'm in the know on that. Okay. A lot of doctors do not, you know, we love our doctors. They know a whole lot more than we know, right? But they are not in the business of preventive care.
Not at all.
At all.
Not at all.
So when you say you have to take your health into your own hands, because see, once you get to the point where you have to be on Lipitor, you have to be on these high blood pressure medications, mm-hmm. you know what I'm talking about.
Yeah.
You are stuck on that medication, and those medications cause other problems.
Complications. Do you not know that 130,000 people died last year from, and hear me on this, they died last year from taking medications as prescribed by their doctors mm-hmm. by expected side effects. So these are people that died based on within the margins of what was to be expected. Do you not know? It was like the year 1987 and 93. I can't remember, but there were the 2 years that the doctors went on strike. Mm-hmm. The death rate in the United States decreased by 5% and 10% respectively each of those years.
Well, I'm not surprised. You know, we have our doctors that have the medication and they're writing the prescriptions, but a lot of our doctors don't know much about the medicine that you're being given.
They don't. You know, you get these pharmaceutical reps that come in and they're just pushing this stuff over.
This man is taking the words out of my mouth. You know what I mean? You better say it again.
Well, and then another thing is,
these pharmaceutical reps are making big money. They come in and they are giving these drugs, selling these drugs to these doctors. The doctors take the drugs. They're not doing their homework, okay, on these cocktails they're giving you. And they write the prescription and...
I'm happy you said cocktails. Yeah. That's where I was going.
Okay.
They'll do a study based on a medication independent, right?
Uh-huh.
There's no comprehensive studies about the interactions when you cross these medications across the board. So if you're on three or four different meds, how these things react in your body. So the goal is, there ain't no pill that grows from the ground. You don't need to be up here popping this for the rest of your life. You know, and if the pill is not getting you better, if it's not take this for a couple of weeks that goes away, that lets you know that you're just addressing a symptom. You know what I mean?
It's not going to go away.
You're not addressing the root. You're addressing the symptom. You know what I'm saying?
Yes. And so, if you're not changing your lifestyle, whether it's a stressful lifestyle, whether you're smoking and drinking, whether you're eating bad, you know, it's like going to get a surgery, you know, for weight loss reduction, but you don't change your habits. Guess what? Your body, I'm taking words out of your mouth now. Body go right back to where it was.
And it goes back worse, actually, because of the fact when you do those weight loss, I've had multiple women come and ask me, Darren, mm-hmm. what are your thoughts? I'm going to tell you right now. Just like your bicep has a predisposed place, fat works the exact same way. You know how, like, some people will put on me when I'm off my thing, I put on fat in my face. I get real chubby cheeks.
Me too.
You know what I mean? Some people put it on in their stomach. Some women put it on their hips and so forth and so on, right? So your body has predetermined fat stores that either get bigger or smaller. What happens is when you're going to get this lipo, you suck out and remove these fat stores. Mm-hmm. So when you put it back on, your body has to make a new fat store. So that's why you see these people that have these weird necks. You see what I'm saying?
A weird butt.
Or something on their butt or something on their arm, because your body just had to create something new. So this is the thing that these doctors are not going to tell
you.
So you just got to be extremely careful with that. You got to be extremely careful with that, you know. You do.
I am loving this. You know, it amazes me how folks would take these different medicated cocktails from a doctor, not knowing how they're going to work in your body, even though they've said it may kill you, but you won't go get a vaccine test.
Well, listen, all right, so I'm happy you said that about the vaccine. So this is a wellness dude, so I mean, you can already see where I'm going to go with that, but I'm not going to put my views on other people. But I will say this.
Okay.
I would, if I was anybody, especially if you're African American, wait until at least the summer, because if you've made it, if you have some kind of pre-existing conditions and you're high risk, then I can understand you being a little more apprehensive, but you made it this far. Wait at least until the summer, get some sunlight, and see what these studies say and come back. Or you can go vegan. I mean, because I got COVID. I didn't even know it. I got COVID, and I lost my sense of smell for 2 days, and that was it. You know what I'm saying? But you got to understand everything I'm doing with my lifestyle, you know. Somebody else can get it and drop. So I'm not here saying that. I'm just saying it's all about what you do here and yes. how different things affect you. But just please wait until after the summer. That's all I'm saying. Go outside and get some sun.
I love what you said. Go get you some vitamin D.
First, okay? Please. And then if you still want to do it, go ahead. You know what I mean?
Yes. You know, people, you guys have heard me say this so many times, okay? And now, you know, the government is coming out, putting folks in the know about the extra virgin coconut oil, okay? And how it kills all lipid-coated viruses, all right? And we're even talking about this COVID, from your HIV to your herpes, right? And so get you some extra virgin coconut oil. Do your homework and see how it helps you. And chop garlic. You know, I've been given this recipe to so many people pre-COVID and during COVID. But chop garlic, because we're talking about stuff that comes from the earth. It is 10 times stronger than penicillin, okay? Mm-hmm. It also helps you with plaque in your arteries. People say, oh, well, my breath going to stink. You want to die? I'm just saying. Chop the garlic, okay? Do your homework on health benefits for chopped garlic. Don't buy it in the store. All right, because it's the same as, you know, cooking out your vegetables. It's not going to have any nutritional value. You want to, as soon as you chop it fresh. You wait for 5 to 8 minutes, okay, and then you swallow. You don't chew it, you swallow it. Just swallow it. And I recently, you know, became ill, and the COVID test came back negative, but something was trying to get me, and I don't get sick. That's one thing in my household. I'm the one who never gets sick. I don't get flus. I don't get colds. I don't get those things. But if something's trying to creep up on me, oh, I go into a war. Mm-hmm. I go and I get my garlic. I get my extra virgin coconut oil. I get my supreme turmeric. I get my olive leaf extract. And this recipe, you know, was produced and found, you know, through my partner, you know, to put that concoction together. You got to know what to put together in order to do that. Mm-hmm. You got to do your homework.
Yeah.
You got to do a lot of research and a lot of studying.
You do.
Because this ain't just one thing. This is a lot of different things that you have to do to get your body to a healthy state. And you got to go in and you got to fight.
I would throw a little ginger in there, too, into
oh,
that
man.
Mix.
Oh, yes. man,
I mean, you'd be burning. You might not be able to talk for a minute, but I would throw a little bit of ginger in there,
too. And that would be my drink.
Yeah.
Because I don't drink, you know, I don't buy juices. Mm-hmm. You know, those sugar juices, you would never see them in my refrigerator.
Nah.
You know, other than the 100%, that pomegranate pom-pom,
yeah.
You'll see that. But I have to squeeze the lemon. I either have to get that fresh lemon and that fresh ginger drink and, you know, and just use that. But it took some time to pull away from it. We get it. You know, we're not perfect. You know, just like you guys aren't perfect. But it's a lifestyle, and you really mentally, you got to buy into that.
I'll tell you what, if you were a trainer, I would hire you right now. And you have the same approach that I do. It's like, I feel like people have been sugarcoated so much that I tell people, they come in and I'm like, if I identify these, you come in, and I can look at your ankles, right? And they're real swollen to certain things. You got five or six different comorbidities. And I tell them flat out, you continue on this path, you're going to die. You know, my mom calls me heartless, but people have to have this wake-up call, in my opinion. Somebody has to tell you
do.
The truth.
Because
you
your life is on the line.
Your life is
and
literally on the line.
We're not going to, you know, we're going to be supportive, you know, but there's no patting you on the back.
You can't. You cannot.
Yeah, because it's your life.
It's your life, yeah. So people have to understand this stuff. So those but then another thing for those listening, the cocktail that she's talking about is going to work great, but in conjunction with she's doing everything else right, because, you know, that's able to go into a clean system and eradicate this. And don't get me wrong, if you're not eating right, that'll still help, mm-hmm. but it's able to work more effectively in somebody who's doing this stuff clean than if it's going into a really acidic, really inflamed environment. You know what I mean? So that's so everything that we're talking about in conjunction, you know what I mean? Because I'm at the point now, I mean, knock on wood, I probably say this and something happened tomorrow, but I don't even know how I could get sick anymore, honestly, with the stuff. I haven't had a cold. I haven't had an itchy throat. I just don't even, Dr. Sabi wasn't playing when he said that look at your dogs. I'd have had my dogs for 9 years and I got them on a raw food. They don't get sick at all. They don't have colds. Nothing ever happens. And I never put two and two. I was like, well, why humans? Why are we always getting a cold or something like this? And I didn't know as a kid that, okay, I'm over here. If you get a cold, any symptom that you have, that we call sickness is actually your body, your immune system metabolizing mm-hmm. the virus or the bacteria. So, for example, if you have a cold and when you have that cough or when your throat hurts, that's not the sickness. That means that your immune system is at work eating the bacteria and the virus, and the byproduct of that causes that symptom, right? Mm-hmm. Well, what was we doing when I was a kid in the 90s? We were taking Robitussin and everything and suppressing those symptoms, which was actually, now that I just explained to y'all how symptoms work and what they really doing, you were suppressing your immune system, and that's why I was having a cold for 2 or 3 weeks. So if you take, I understand that you might not feel good and this, that, and the third, and the Robitussin, it'll help you get through the day, and the cough drops, it'll help you talk at work.
Yes.
But having a cold for 3 weeks is not normal. I mean,
that's,
I guess,
not normal.
I know the cold don't exist no more, not a COVID here, you know, but having the flu for a month, that's not normal.
No,
that's,
it's not.
Those medications are suppressing your system, so you have to go through that.
Get to a place of healing.
A place of healing, exactly. So that's what it is. So just be conscious of what you're doing and address the root, not the symptoms. You know, if you out here on crack, well, let me stop. I need to stop going to those analogies. But am I going to go shoot your drug dealer, or am I going to address your drug issue? You see what I'm saying?
Absolutely.
Yeah, and that's how you have to look at it when people are up here talking about these symptoms versus the root of the issue. And just look at the root, and preventative care is the way to go.
You know, we're about to go to a quick break, everyone. We got some comments coming in, you know, on our social media. We have Greg. He says garlic also feeds good bacteria as a natural prebiotic.
Mm-hmm.
Okay. We have Mr. Body Soul Fitness. He says, oh, yes, y'all talking my language. Garlic, ginger, greens galore. Mm-hmm. You know, hey, Cindy B. She's loving this conversation. Listen, y'all, we love all y'all. Thank you so much for sharing your comments. Please share the video. This is great information, not just for you, but for your friends and family, too. You're listening to In the Know with RJ Powell on Power 108.9. We'll be right back.
Yo, looking for a new house? Then it's time for you to holler at our guy, the mortgage guy, Alvin Jameson of Loan Depot. Yo, it's your boy Michael McFadden of Mornings with Michael and Friends, and I tell you what, Alvin Jameson and the crew, they really do it all. First-time home buyers, refinances, investment properties, VA home loans too. Hit them up. It's very simple. AlvinJameson.com. Y'all know Alvin like the chipmunk, Jameson like that fine whiskey. You can also hit them up by... It's tax time, ladies and gentlemen, and this year, Mills Financial Group has some amazing programs for all of us, especially, though, if you're a truck driver, contract worker, real estate professional, and definitely those that are self-employed. Now, Mills Financial will get you the maximum refund you deserve. We're talking cash advances up to $9,500 in just 1 hour. Want to get started? Give them a call, 877-634-6299. Now, Mills Financial Group has several locations across the United States of America, including Philly, New Orleans, and our favorite location, the Battery Atlanta, home of the Atlanta Braves, making tax season that much easier for you. Call them, 877-634-6299. Now, 2020 was tough, and Mills Financial Group wants to help you get what you deserve during tax season. Hit them up, 877-634-6299, or visit the website Mills Financial Group. That's MILLZ financialgroup.com. They got your back. Yo, it's Michael McFadden for our friends over at Credit Building Professionals. You know what they do? They help their clients achieve better credit. How? Late payments, fraud, liens, charge-offs, student loans. They do it all. Get results in 30 to 90 days, and it's very simple to contact them. Hit them up on their website, creditbuildingprofessionals.com, or give them a call, 678-447-2012. Once again, 678-447-2012. Tell them you heard it on Power 108.9. What up, Credit Craig?
Question: who has an idea for a new app? Well, if you answer yes to that question, it's time for you to holler at our friends over at Appsketeers. Yo, it's Michael McFadden of Power 108.9 and the crew over at Appsketeers to take great care of you. Nick and the Gang provides you with the all-in-one app development experience. I'm talking design, UI, UX, coding, and a whole bunch more. And if you have no clue what that means, it's time for you to holler at Appsketeers. Check out the website, appsketeers.com. Now, we're talking full confidentiality, no hassle, no obligation. If you don't believe me, just call them. 833-APP-IDEA. That's 833-APP-IDEA. As a matter of fact, you know what they do? They design, they build, and they launch. Tell them you heard it on Power 108.9. And don't forget to ask for the governor. What up, Nick?
Keep up with Power 108.9 on social media.
How can I find you?
Instagram.
At Power 108.9.
And Facebook.
At Power 108.9.
It's the exact same thing. It's at Power 108.9.
Oh. Oh, okay.
Power 108.9. A station for the people.
In a world of petty and immature people, it's refreshing to hear a morning show that has sophisticated hosts such as Michael McFadden and Jay Nash. Don't believe me? Take a listen.
But shout out to our friends over there at Credit Building Professionals. What up, Credit Craig?
I tried to come with you.
Yeah, thank you very much. That's what she said.
Oh.
Hey. Power 108.9, a station for the people.
You know how I give you be playing the right songs. All right, y'all. We are back. If you're just tuning in, I'm your host tonight, RJ Powell. You're listening to In the Know on Power 108.9. And we have our special guest, Mr. Darren McClary.
Hey, y'all.
Yes, yes. Hey, y'all. Hey, Darren.
Hey.
I love it. I love it. All right, all right, all right. So, okay, so today we're talking about health and fitness and everything in between, y'all. You know, I know that you are a fitness and wellness coach. What are some of your clients' biggest objections when it comes to working out?
Ooh, that's a good one.
Mm-hmm.
That's a real good one. Okay, so I would say, I've been doing this for almost 10 years. I would say the lies that they tell themselves.
Love it. Okay.
Honestly.
Yes.
The lies that they tell themselves. So, for example, you want to get in shape. You know, and everybody does want to get in shape. Don't get me wrong. Mm-hmm. But people will do these contradictory behaviors. So this is why I'm talking about the lies that they tell themselves. So I had a client and, you know, she was, I mean, I'm talking losing tons of weight, man. She had a big goal to get to and she had lost about 40. I think I took 45, 50 pounds off of her.
Okay.
And then she, I couldn't understand why her weight started going back up. Right. So what was going on is she was leaving the sessions after doing this hard work because, in my opinion, she had been big her whole life,
mm-hmm.
and I think she was scared to become this other person. You see what I'm saying?
So this new-looking person.
This new-looking – well, it's actually a new person altogether because once you – people don't understand that when you get to a certain level of unhealth and disease, mm-hmm. dis-ease, a lot of these fat stores are holding on to a lot of toxins, right?
Mm-hmm.
Like a lot of so as soon as your body has a toxin – you can either excrete it through the skin or through feces or so forth and so on. And unfortunately for folks, if you have a lot of fat cells, your body will just pack it away
mm-hmm.
because it views fat as fat is pretty much walled off. I don't know how much you guys know about the way fat is stored.
Mm-hmm.
So your body will store toxins. And these toxins, when they're broken down, get re-released into your system and they can flood your system and affect your brain.
Yes.
So quite literally, when you're on a weight loss journey, you're becoming a whole new person. But I digress. So back to what I was saying. What happened was she had lost 40, 50 pounds. And she started putting on weight, and I couldn't understand what was going on. And this lady was kicking butt. I mean, she's in here working out harder than anybody that you would ever see.
Okay.
She admitted to me, Darren, you know what? Vegan girl, I'm leaving, Darren. I'm eating ice cream when I leave. I am eating Doritos when I leave and so forth and so on. I'm like, well, why are you doing this in this work? And then she told me flat out, she was like, you know, Darren, I'm going to be honest with you. I am a emotional eater. Well, anytime you say I am, anything after I am, you are claiming.
That's right.
And you are becoming that. You
uh-huh.
see what I'm saying? So when I'm talking about the lies that people are telling themselves, you are whether you're an emotional eater or not, do you still want to be that? You see
right.
what I'm saying? So
right.
once you say that and you identify with that, you become that.
That.
You
mm-hmm.
see what I'm saying?
Mm-hmm.
So when I say the lies that these people are telling themselves, I'm talking about they'll come in, they'll do a lot of stuff that seems to be the right things, mm-hmm. but then 9 times out of 10, they have some kind of self-sabotaging thing that's in play,
yes.
and they'll say, oh, well, Darren, I am this. Well, Darren, I am a mother. I'm a single. You know how many mm-hmm. other mothers I'm training?
Yes.
You know what I'm saying? That has nothing on it. Oh, Darren, you know what? I am a diabetic. You know how many people I've gotten off of insulin? You see what I'm saying? So once they say these I ams, they don't understand how powerful they are and that they're becoming that and that they're aligning with that.
Yes.
They're self-sabotaging themselves. So yes. that, when I say the lies that they're telling themselves, they're claiming anything other than I'm successful, I am in shape, I
yes.
am healthy, I
yes.
am well, anything other than that, I don't know why you're saying it about yourself, honestly. So that's what I mean when I talk about the lies that they've told themselves.
No, I love that. I love that. And a lot of folks, you know, we're claiming death. You know, you know what I'm talking about. We're claiming it. I yeah. have this disease. I got that disease. You know, I'm surprised that she was still losing weight, even though she was sneaking off doing these other.
Well, because she was doing like you working out 3 hours a day. You know
oh,
what I mean?
Well, that's different. When you're working strong like that.
And I'm happy you talked about disease. Let's talk yeah. about that too, right? Okay, so you're talking about I have diabetes. It's no such thing as diabetes. You have an insulin level, and it's either higher or lower than that, and you have a resistance to that, right?
Mm-hmm.
But if I explain it like that, you can do something about that. But if I have diabetes, that's this whole thing that I got to go work on, right?
Mm.
I have cancer. You ain't got no cancer. You have mm-hmm. a mutated cell, right? So if I tell you have a mutated cell, you can go do something about that,
right.
Okay? You see what I'm saying?
Yes.
And when you talk about all these other things, when you talk about specifically what they are, they're just polarized on one side, either positively or negatively, or up and down,
right.
But when you explain it like that, you can break it down and do something about that. That's why they came up with these ailments for you to put on yourself and believe in. You see what I'm saying?
Mm-hmm.
So I'm not saying that these sicknesses don't exist.
Right.
The definition and the ailments and the way that we talk about them disassociates the cause, which is something that we can address, to an ailment or a malady, which is something that you just look at it like, oh my God, this is something that I need somebody else
mm-hmm.
to help me with. You know
mm-hmm.
what I'm saying?
Mm-hmm.
So, you know, high blood pressure. Listen, you got an issue with sodium sensitivity. You know what I mean?
That's what you got to deal with.
That's what you
right.
got to deal with. So that's where we come up, or I ain't going to say we. That's where they came up with these ailments, and then they put them on us, and then people believe in that stuff, and
yes.
they go in and act accordingly. So that's what that is.
You know, it's harder to deal with heart disease. It's harder to deal with cancer or diabetes than it is to actually deal with the root of the cause, okay?
Right.
Maybe I'm eating too much sugar. Maybe I need to cut out too many of the carbs, or the white rice and the white breads and all the things that when it go into my system, my body sees it as sugar.
Mm-hmm.
Maybe I need to tackle that part as opposed to trying to fight diabetes.
Right.
Because that's too scary.
That is scary.
That runs us to the doctor, where we have to now take that medication, and now you got some new issues, and you still haven't even dealt with the root.
With the
because
root.
You're allowing the pill to do it for you.
Exactly.
Mm-hmm.
Exactly. You're right. And you hit the nail right on the head. So like I said, these names and these titles, I have. We just talked about this with the lies they telling themselves. I ain't going to step as far and say
listen,
that
that's
again.
That's a good
but,
book.
But yeah, but the lies they tell them. Seriously, I have this thing. And it's just like, it disassociates and it takes you away from a place of empowerment and knowing what it is that you're talking about, which is something you can address and deal with. You know, you talk about somebody talking about, I got cystic fibrosis. What is that? Tell me what that is. How do
mm-hmm.
How can I work on something like that? And I don't even know what the word means. I'm telling everybody, my doctor said I got cystic fibrosis, so I got to take these pills and so much and so forth and so on. Or, you know, so it's the people need to really look into and become your own expert. If you have a malady, please. I'm not saying that these things don't exist, but
mm-hmm.
if you have it, become your own expert. Become your own advocate.
Ooh,
find out what that is. Educate yourself, take away that malady, and then the next time somebody asks you what's wrong with them, tell them, well, this, that, and the third. I got this. My cells are doing this. My body's doing this. My blood is doing this, and this is what I'm doing to rectify that.
Right.
As opposed to, oh, well, I got cystic fibrosis. What is that, sis? I don't understand. What you talking about?
Right.
You know what I'm saying? So
yes.
That's all I'm saying. Let's put the power of health and wellness back into the hands of the people that need to be healthy and well, as opposed to the people that want to give you a pill and keep you coming back for a prescription every couple weeks.
Right, right.
You know.
You know, so many people, especially, you know, because you're a millennial, correct?
I don't know.
Yes. you don't seem or feel like one, but yes, that age group. But, you know, you guys have, I won't say you guys, but, you know, the wave of the millennials, you know, have really introduced this, I work for myself,
mm.
okay? Because, you know, where I come from, you know, folks, they work on their job 30, 40 years, you know. But everybody, I know, see there?
We ain't doing that.
Everybody is an entrepreneur. Everybody have businesses. And I just want to say, you know, treat your body like you treat your business.
Oh, I like that.
You know, because when you get your business, that's your baby. Mm-hmm. You're trying to grow her. You working on her, right, every single day to get her better. And if I think if we put the same energy that we put into our businesses, you know, into our bodies, then we can be a whole lot more effective, you know, when it comes to our health, wellness, and fitness programs.
You know I'm going to take that, right?
You going to take that?
You're
going to use that?
I am using that. I had not thought about it like that. I'm definitely using that.
Yes, yeah. I love it. You know what? Everything's from the head up. Everything from the neck up. It's how we process what we process.
Yeah.
And, you know, we can't see the light. You know, if we got the door closed, it's like you got to open the door. You got to get out of your head. Mm-hmm. Like you say, you know, we're claiming, and like I said, we're claiming death.
Yeah, you're right. You hit the nail on the head with that.
And get out of your head because you're claiming these things. And once you claim them, you know, it's like calling those things which be not as though they were. I'm sick.
Mm-hmm.
You know, well, then you're going to be sick.
You're going to be sick.
You know, it's like I can't sleep. I got sleep deprivation.
You're going to be up.
But you're going to be up because if you don't claim every day, man, I can't wait till I get some good sleep tonight. I'm going to rest so good.
Mm-hmm.
You know? You start practicing words are power.
Extremely powerful.
You know, when you put it out here into the universe, that's what it is. So watch what you say.
Yeah.
Right?
Watch what you say. People don't understand the power of words and vibration and all that stuff. You're going to get me talking spiritual now, but it's just like, you know, everything has a meaning. There's no such thing as coincidence, and I don't believe in it at least. You know what I mean?
Mm-hmm.
And somebody can literally, I mean, when you write out a word, what do? You spell it. You're putting a spell on somebody, and people don't even understand that. And if I'm your doctor, you know what I mean? Y'all going to have me. I guess I sound like the doctor's evil. I'm not saying doctors are evil. But if you have a doctor coming out, and they're spelling out a prescription with one of these maladies, and then you get this thing, you don't understand. Folks like that I know from back home will see these things and believe these things, and they get so caught up in this, right, that from the day one, I've seen people literally digress their health in 24 hours. They'll have a diagnosis, right?
Yes.
They'll find out something from their doctor. They will have, and this is on everything I love. At my church, I saw this happen with a dude with HIV. And he had this, and he had the diagnosis and all this. His health decreased within a week. Went back to the doctor, found out he was misdiagnosed. Now, he gave himself all the symptoms. You see what I'm saying? Because he owned that he didn't even have HIV. He was misdiagnosed, but he gave himself through the power of belief. That's why they call something a placebo effect. They call a placebo to take away the power of your mind. If you're telling me right now, if I gave you a sugar pill, that 60%, the placebo is so powerful that 60% of participants can will themselves into a cure.
Yes.
But they take the power away from the mind and just say, oh, well, that's placebo. That's what you talk. I just cured myself by thinking that this pill was something else.
Mm-hmm,
that's powerful. That's powerful, Bo. How about we call it that? You know what I mean?
I love that.
But they don't want you to know that. So what I'm saying is people put these words here, and it's all designed to get you to think. I agree with you, RJ. Death. You know what I mean? Claim death and to claim negativity and to claim anything other than your greatness and your health and your wellness. Mm-hmm, so just again, research. Learn, and just be healthy. It's really not that hard.
You know, the brain is, oh, gosh, like we're talking about, so powerful. And, you know, you can have a sickness and end up being okay from that sickness because of the positive attitude towards it. And then some people can have a sickness, and they just drive themselves to death because how they're processing that sickness. You know, in October for Breast Cancer Awareness Month, you know, we celebrated that and had a guest on the show, and she was a 2-time breast cancer survivor. Mm. When I tell you the best personality, oh my gosh, just so happy, you know, even through that process, you know, she kept her spirits lifted. She dang near healed herself.
Yep.
You know, just with the vibrations, with the positivity, and not claiming death, right? Have people who don't even have cancer. They may have, you know, they're killing themselves just from stress, the way they're processing what's going on.
I agree 100%. 100%. Mm-hmm. If you look, you can just look at people. I say this all the time on my IG. You can just look at, take your most positive friends, right? and look at their lives, the people that just you would call to have, I guess I'm one of them, the people that you would call to have glass full, look at those people and look at their lives and their health. Then take the people that you know that are inherently negative,
yes,
and look at their lives and look at their health and tell me if there's not a correlation there.
Mm-hmm.
You know what I'm saying?
Yes.
So it's just, it's what we put ourselves around. It's what we put in our minds. It's what we think about. You know what I mean? I was watching this guy. That he was one of my professors in undergrad. So my degree is in, believe it or not, as a wellness coach. My degree is in political science, and I have a minor in Africana studies.
Okay.
And man, this blew my mind. I remember hearing this in Africana studies. My professor told, I used to go to all the African-American museums and watch slavery. We had this one in Detroit where it was like the ship, and they showed where the slaves were at the bottom and all that stuff like that. And I thought I was doing my due diligence. And he was like, look, man. If your mother got raped, would she make a statue of the rapist and then go look at this dude annually every year? This is what they're doing to us, and this is they're giving federal dollars for y'all to see your embarrassment and your shame and to keep remembering that. Why are they not making a temple about the Egyptian pharaohs and kings and so forth and so on? Mm-hmm. But they'll show you these guys chained up. If you were molested, would you make a statue of the molester and then go take your son to see that every year?
Mm-hmm.
And I was like, wow, I never thought about it like that. You know, I was going to these places and I was getting really upset, like, what's going on and why are they doing it? But why do we have monuments like that? You know what I mean? So I just say all that to say that the mind, as you were saying, is so powerful, and the things that you believe and the things that you allow in will completely affect your reality. And like how we were talking about, again, look at the people that believe positively about their lives and look at their lives and then look at the folks that are negative
absolutely.
And so forth and so on.
Absolutely. So. You know, there are so many ways to get our bodies to a state of wellness. And I want to talk about mindlessness meditation.
Yeah.
Yes, that's the next level meditation.
Yeah. Well, I guess mindlessness. I'm sure you mean mindfulness, but yeah, mindlessness meditation.
Mindfulness, being mindful. Excuse me. Thank you for that correction. Yes.
No, I'm playing with you.
No, that's because we want to make sure that they're in the know correctly.
Okay.
Yes.
Okay. Yeah,
mindfulness.
Mindfulness meditation. So yes. Mindfulness meditation is a huge thing in. In the corporate world, they're calling this mindfulness coaching, you know, because meditation ain't made it all the way to where it can just be trendy enough to be in the corporate world, but it's the exact same thing.
Mm-hmm.
So all mindfulness meditation is when you sit down and you're not thinking about the future, you're not thinking about the past, you're being present in the moment. And the easiest way that, you know, to do that is to focus on your breath. So people, you'll focus on, you know, you'll breathe in on a cadence of, you know, 3, 4, 5, depending on how big your lungs are, and you go out the same way.
Mm-hmm.
You do that for about 10 or 15 minutes, and you only focus on your breath. Now, every time I teach these meditation classes, people come out and they're like, well, you know, Darren, my thoughts are wandering and so forth and so on. That's fine, right? So if I'm breathing in and out, 1, 2, 3, 4, 1, 2, 3, 4, out, and I'm following that, and I think, oh, God, I got to get up at 7 tomorrow and train somebody, that's fine, but that ain't got nothing to do with right now. So bring myself back here, and I keep breathing. Then another thought. Well, man, look, I might need to go. I want to buy this Tesla next week. Let me go get this money. Well, Darren, that ain't got nothing to do with right now. Bring myself back here. And you just constantly, you don't want to fight anything, because anything you fight, the energy just becomes stronger. You just acknowledge it, and then you just let it go, and then you just come back to the breathing.
I see.
And you do that for 10 or 15 minutes, and you really get into a place where it's just you. You're just there with yourself, and it's really quiet. And from a wellness standpoint, the studies have shown that is great at relieving stress, depression, lowering blood pressure.
Are you kidding me? And it helps trains people who cannot get away from stress.
Exactly. Exactly.
You know, it helps you train, because that's all. Stress is just, you know, your mind won't rest.
Your mind won't
rest. You can't sleep because your mind won't rest.
Yeah,
so it's probably good for people to help them sleep as well.
It's great for sleep. It's great for so many other things. And another thing it does is, I mean, we were just talking about the power of thought.
Mm-hmm.
It teaches you to control your thoughts. So imagine if you were in 90, because a lot of people, you just sit here and all kind of stuff pop in your mind, right? Mm-hmm. Negative or positive. Imagine when you're in 90, 95% control of what comes in your mind and you're willing yourself to only have positive thoughts. You know what I'm saying? Think about the lifestyle changes that you can have there. Yeah. So meditation has a lot of good applications. So.
Yes, yes. That it's one of those things we forget to do. Like we were discussing earlier, where you can walk, you can jog, you do your weight training. Yoga is really good. There's so many things, but we forget that. And of course, fasting. But we forget meditation.
Meditation.
How important is meditation? And in the Black community, you know, we just didn't grow up with meditation. You know what I'm saying? Folks didn't grow up doing meditation.
We didn't.
You know, but it is something that we do need to adapt in our lifestyles and teach it to our children as well.
Yeah.
Mm-hmm.
I agree. I've taught my son.
It's a big part of wellness.
It is. It's a huge part of wellness.
Yes.
Is doing that. And you know what? We touched on the charcoal. Do you mind? Can I talk about the charcoal
for
a second?
Please, can we talk about this activated
charcoal? Charcoal. Mm-hmm. So listen, they did a study. It was a really bad study the way they did this, man. These scientists, I don't know. It was something called the LD90. So what it is LD90 stands for lethal dose 90. So it's how much of a substance do we have to give these animals before we can kill 90% of them? Okay, so that's what the LD90 study was.
Okay.
Well, they did it on rats with activated charcoal. And they found out that it did the opposite. It kept extending their life. No matter how old the rats were, it kept extending their life. Dig this. So one rat got to be so old. The study went so long, they just had to kill the rat so that they could produce and publish the study. So activated charcoal increased these rats' lifespan by 40%, no matter where they started. So if you're a human and you live to be 100, you're talking about living to be 140. And this is the reason that it's powerful. Okay. So what activated charcoal does is it detoxes your body completely, okay? So it's an adsorber with a D, an adsorber, not an AB. Absorber means it takes something in and it becomes a part of it, right? An adsorber means that it molecularly bonds to the outside of it, right? So your body can't process activated charcoal, and it attracts all these chemicals to it, so it passes through your system. They don't even completely understand how it does this.
Okay.
And it takes all the toxins out and gets it out when you let it out, right? So if you were to go to the hospital right now and you drank a bunch of rat poison, so I don't know why you do it, but if you did something like that, the first thing they're going to do is they're going to give you this big glass of this black stuff that's activated charcoal, right?
Yes.
So when you take this stuff on the nightly, because you got to think about all the toxins that we're exposed to on the daily. I'm talking there's chemicals coming out of your clothes that you don't even think about the air.
Soaps, detergents.
Everything. We're constantly being bombarded with this stuff. Mm-hmm. So I have a regimen of taking activated charcoal in the morning and at night.
All right.
And especially for folks, if you're drinking, oh my God, you talk about a hangover cure.
Alcohol, yes. It does help with that. Yes.
Completely. You know what I mean? So activated charcoal, I would say everybody, if you can't get on that stuff. You know, I'm actually going to talk about that on Wellness Wednesday on my page today, but get on the activated charcoal. It would literally change your life completely and just get the toxins out.
You know, what will help make it taste better, too, is squeeze some lemon in it.
Yeah.
Mm-hmm. Squeeze you some lemon in it. If you're a juicer, you can add you some cucumber, you know, a light flavor. And it's good for your teeth, too.
Oh, yeah, yeah. Listen, I was brushing my teeth with it. You can brush your teeth with it. Do you have the powder or were you taking the pills?
Powder.
The powder?
Yes.
See, but it get everywhere, though. You know what I'm saying?
The pill, you better. Oh, that's the truth. It's like graphite.
It is, yeah.
It's like, you know, the graphite that you use from a pencil, y'all. I used to do architectural blueprints and stuff like that. Mm. And before we do it into the CAD, you know, we hand draft that, and we use the graphite to hand draft it. Man, that graphite gets everywhere. So yeah, it's kind of messy. But it does come in a pill. If you're going to take it, you can't take it in a pill.
You get more for your money with the. I have both. I have the powder and the pill. So I take powder. But it's to the point
but
where
you
I'm
do the powder with your teeth, or you just do the powder and pour it into your drink.
Well, so what I do is, you know, you ever seen them dudes in the gym? I'm the dude that'll put the pre-workout in and then just drink the water.
I see.
So I do that with the charcoal, too.
So you in the gym with black teeth. I'm just kidding.
I have, yes. You are not lying. Yes, that is me. First thing in the morning. You see me at 5, 6 in the morning. My teeth are black until 5:30 every morning.
But you know what? But you see how your attitude is towards it? It's like, I don't care. It's all good because I know what it's doing for my body.
For my body, yeah.
Mm-hmm.
Exactly.
Your attitude is if, hey, you just, you know, went out and bought you a Mercedes. You know, people say, you know, they buy all these nice things. It's like, oh, yeah, that's mine. They're feeling real good.
Yeah.
And it's not adding any value to your health.
No value to your health.
Mm-hmm.
Zero.
Yes, yes, yes. I see you over there. Y'all, I can't, you know, the time does be flying by. We are really at the top of the hour. We're going to be bringing you that We're going to be bringing you that In the Know nugget. Right, which is that inspirational In the Know nugget. I want to, before we close out, I do want to talk about these 5 C's getting out of your own way. Okay, I came up with these 5 C's that get you out of your own way. Okay, and that is, you want to be, that is consistency. Okay, you want to be consistent. Commitment. Okay, you have to be committed. That's what we're talking about, buying into the lifestyle of health and wellness and fitness. Confidence. We don't think about the confidence because, see, when we do better, we are better. When we feel good, when we look good, we feel good. And that's where that confidence, you know, remember earlier you were speaking about the lady who, she was working out, but then she was eating bad foods. Mm-hmm. And she said, well, you know, I'm not ready to be, you know, this other person. Yeah. It's that confidence.
Yeah, confidence.
You know, conviction. Conviction is another one. You know, when you look in the mirror and you feel convicted, yes, that's your body telling you, I need to do something. If you don't feel a conviction, then you're just comfortable where you at.
Yeah.
And that's where we don't want to be, right? In celebration. Celebrate your wins. You know? You go, I don't care if you lost a pound, lost 2 pounds. Maybe you, you know, got your cholesterol levels down. Whatever it is, celebrate yourself.
Celebrate.
Every time there's something going on, everybody want to go get some alcohol. Let's celebrate. It's such and such birthday. Let's celebrate. I got this going on. Well, celebrate your health.
Yeah.
Yes? Do you agree?
I agree wholeheartedly. Celebrate your health.
I love it. So, Darren, you got to come back on the show.
Yeah, it was a good time.
Yes, and we got to have Brent.
Yeah,
your business
sure.
partner. We definitely got to have Brent. Hey, Brent, we got to have you on the show. Put folks in the know again how they can find you, your company, Thoroughbred Wellness.
Mm-hmm. Yeah.
Okay, and your IG.
So my IG is Darren the Dynamic because I do so many things. So you can find me at Darren the Dynamic on Instagram or Facebook. The company name is Thoroughbred Wellness. So we made it real easy. You can find us at thoroughbredwellness.com or at Thoroughbred Wellness on Instagram. And if you want to, you know, just lose some weight online and, you know, you're not interested in coming to the gym, check out thebiggestloserchallenge.com.
Thank you.
And you can check that out. And there it is. You know.
And thebiggestloser.com is it every day?
Well, it's actually Biggest Loser Challenge. I'm sorry. I got to be really
biggest
specific.
Loser
biggest
Challenge.
Loser, biggestloserchallenge.com.
Mm-hmm.
She won the show, so we were able to use their branding.
I love
you know
it.
What I mean? But that's what it is. So, yeah, it's online. It's not every day. We don't have a current challenge running. The next one should be coming up. What is it? March? I think we got one scheduled for like March 3rd
okay.
or something like that.
And that's online.
It is online, virtual. You know, so anywhere in the country, you can do this from from the comfort of your own home.
And Thoroughbred Wellness is open how many days a week?
We are, now you have me working. No, I'm playing. We are open Monday. We are open Monday through Saturday. You know what
okay.
I mean? By appointment.
By appointment.
But the website, you can go and you can book either myself or one
wonderful.
Of my trainers right on the website. So
that's wonderful, wonderful. Thank you for being on In the Know.
You're very welcome.
Yes.
Good time. Very good time.
And y'all know where y'all can find me. I'm In the Know with RJ on all platforms. Please visit my Facebook business page, In the Know with RJ Powell. Like it and you know, leave me a review. So let's go ahead and get to that In the Know nugget. All right, so you have one body for one life. Nothing's more important than your health. You can gain all the success you want, but you will never enjoy it with bad health. A daily nutritional diet coupled with exercise is more crucial than it has ever been before. We are in a war against a deadly virus, deadly foods, and deadly behaviors that impact our wellness. 2020 was the year of death. Let's make 2021 the year for better living by adapting better wellness habits for healthier hearts, healthier lives, and healthier relationships. Thank you all so much for supporting and watching the In the Know platform. You're listening to Power 108.9. We'll see you guys next Monday, same time. We love you guys. Good night.
And I was convinced it would be all right. Now things are strange, nothing's the same. And really, I just want my friend back.